Okay, stream. Now the stream should be good. I had to end it, the other one, because OBS decided my mic didn't exist, but now we fixed it. OBS does this thing where sometimes it just sets everything to default. I don't know why it does that, but we're live. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Assassin's Creed Origins. Now I'm joking. But we're going to be doing Beyond Two Souls. This is the beginning of the playthrough, and Niall, I do see you in here. What's up, dude? And we're going to be doing a chronological playthrough, because the last time we did, I think it was out of order, but if you do the remix, it's in chronological order, so I think we'll start from the beginning and play it as it's told, you know? Nutty, how are you? I'm doing okay. I guess I'm not doing the best. I guess I'm okay. But Juicy YT Giggity, thanks for joining Juicy YT. I appreciate you. The giggity thing. Apparently Quagmire has joined my streams. But the thing that's weird is that you think it'd be called original, because the remix one is in chronological order. So I don't really understand. I mean, shouldn't the names be swapped? But I missed previous stream because I had a migraine. Oh, you're fine. You're fine. To be honest, you didn't really miss anything. It's my old channel. I just renamed it. Oh, wait. Is that a fucking Juicy dude? Oh, what's up, dude? Yeah, I forgot. I thought that was somebody new. My bad. But this game does have two-player mode. But it's really nothing special, though, because one person plays as Jody and then the other plays as Aiden. I play video games often. I rarely play video. I guess I play video games often. No, I don't play games at all. I'm just. But yeah, this game is very story driven. So there's going to be a lot of cutscenes where I might not talk just to listen to it. But since I'm playing in chronological order, we'll be starting from when she's a child. So it'll go in as the events are displayed. But can you say hi? I'm Quagmire.
Hi, I'm Glenn Quagmire. I can't do his voice.
Oh, Jesus.
I need to remember.
I gotta make sure the game isn't too quiet. I do have a problem where sometimes I make the game too quiet and people can't really hear it. I've gotten better with it though.
If I had to.
Oh my god, it's Elliot Page. Holy shit. Back when it was called. When she was. Or my bad. When they were called Ellen Page. My bad. You sound like you molest women. You molest women in a pickup truck. Who's to say I don't? No, I'm joking. I better not say. Oh my god, I better shut up before I get taken down. Oh, jeez.
Giggity, giggity. Giggity goo.
I'm joking. But I do hope you guys are doing good.
Did someone try to hurt you?
Wait a minute. Is this in chronological order? Or I'm confused. It should be. Hey, yo, proof. I mean,
someone I could contact.
You can't prove me wrong, Niall. Because what if I do? Yeah, that's a bit sus, Nutty. I'm kidding. I'm kidding. Like, I'm kidding. I promise. I'm not like that. I'm joking. No, I better stop. If it goes in chronological order, it should start when she's a child. Because there's parts in this game where he plays her as a kid. But this game is I actually like it. It's very story driven. It's like you play as this girl named Jody, and she has a dead brother named Aiden, and it's like he's like an alter ego type thing. I don't know. I can't really explain it. But I would put the title of Two Souls, One Chick, you know, like the not-so-very... I mean,
scar?
I didn't think about it in the moment, but... I mean, I can always go back and change it. But not right now, though, because that's not really important. Holy shit, you see that frame rate drop? The game said, whenever she hit the cup against the wall. Oh, God.
Got to stop that. They have no idea what...
It's the green goblin! Holy shit, guys! Look, it's the green fucking goblin! PS5 is amazing. Yeah, it's a nice system.
You've got to stop them!
There's a few drawbacks with it, though.
Goddamn my fools.
Oh my god, so I guess Norman didn't die. Oh my god. So many frame rats. What the hell? Oh, the 60 FPS, yeah. The PS5 is a nice system, but there's a few things about it that I don't like, though. The one thing I don't like is that you can't change the theme. Like, it's like everybody has the same, like, music and shit. Like, on the PS4 you can do that, but on the PS5 you can't, which is weird. But shit's the bed on Little Big Planet. Yeah, exactly, yeah. Especially when you go into a server and shit with other people. Holy shit, is that the SWAT team? Yes, it is. Or Manhunt. No, I'm joking. It's the Cursor City Police. He went. He looked like Woody from Toy Story. His arm just went. Like, it just ragdolled. Oh,
my sinuses are shitting the bed right now.
But I do hope everybody's doing good. And to be honest, you really didn't miss much last time. There was... I think, all in all, I think a total maybe 5 people showed up. It was a pretty relaxed stream. There wasn't many people in there. But it was still fun. I had fun with it. But I will warn you guys, though. This game is... It's at times it can be on the boring side, at times, but it gets better. Listen, it's a very slow-paced game, because it's, if anything, this should have just been a movie. I don't even know why they made it into a game. Like, the PS3 was capable of playing two games. Like, I'm built different with a PS5 or a PS4 game. Why, mommy, pick me up, my frame rates are shit. Pretty much, so you mean Elise, my daughter? Pretty much my daughter is like that. God forbid you put her on the bed, it's game over. Oh, shit. This movie, or the, I said this movie, this game kind of reminds me of Carrie, if you guys know what Carrie. Your daughter's a piece of plastic. Yeah, my daughter's my PS5, I turned her into a PS5. I'm joking. I have a baby doll, I don't have an actual daughter. No, but I mean, it's true though. I mean, she's at that stage where she wants to be held all the time, which can get pretty frustrating after a while. Wait, how would plugs work? That's a secret we're not going to get into. We're not going to go into that. Like, I don't even want to think about it. Yeah, me either. But yeah, this game is good. It's just, it was made by the same people that made Heavy Rain. If you remember Cameron, he streamed Heavy Rain. It's the same developer as Heavy Rain. See how the boot up sounds? Oh Jesus. Yeah, so you start when she's a kid. The fans doing the loudest thing. Oh yeah, and see, that is one of the things I hated about the PS3 and the PS4. They both sound like they were about to take off from a fucking airstrip.
Ah, there you are.
Jesus. In Germany, we don't have a speed limit.
Good.
Germany? Wait a minute. Bother you when you... Is that actually... Wait, I thought you were from...
I believe it's...
That's crazy. Jesus. So what, do people die on a consistent basis? Because some people like to drive slow, other people like to drive fast. In Wales, we don't have a fucking kilometer. I don't really know. Yeah, this game has really weird controls. If you don't do the full animation, it resets, and you have to redo the entire fucking thing. It's like, really? Oh, shit, my webcam froze. OBS did that earlier. Hold on, guys. Oh, my God. Are you kidding me? It was doing this to me earlier, guys. Just hold on. My webcam died. Wait a minute, is it? Yeah, there we go. Yeah, sorry about that. It was doing that earlier, like my webcam froze. I hate OBS. OBS is a piece of shit. See, the actions are in-game. Smash your controller against the wall. It's like you actually have to, like, throw it against the wall. Hold on, what? If I go up to my dollhouse.
Come on, girl, you'll have plenty of time to play later.
I don't want to play later. I want to play right now. Fucking asshole. No, I'm joking. But yeah, I'm really sorry about that, because that happened earlier. I was getting shit ready, and my webcam just froze.
Waiting for us.
You gotta love OBS. It's like a baby. It always shits the bed. Like, if one thing a baby can't figure out, fuck's wrong. Force your child to step on Legos barefoot? Oh, God. No, I would never do that, because that's painful. Is that pizza over there? What the fuck? But I will say this, though. We have done a playthrough of this game before, and the last playthrough was okay. I didn't really pay much attention to the game, though, but I slammed down. I don't know about that. I don't think I want to slam my controller.
Jordan.
What do you want? He's like, come on, Jody. He's like, I'm going to freeze your webcam. He's like, I want to play with my dolls. He's like, yeah, motherfucker, well, I'm going to freeze your fucking webcam. Oh, my God. But yeah, I will be honest, though. As of late, things have been very, very stressful. Like I said in the Discord, we're not going to get into it. But life has been very, very stressful lately, but I'm just not going to get into it. Yeah, let me play some dolls. What the fuck? It's like you slam your foot down. It's like, I want to play with my dolls. You know how kids are when they don't get their fucking way. But, yeah, this game is okay. I would say, if I had to get out and base it on a scale of 1 to 10,
hey, Joe.
I would give it a solid...
How's your day been so far?
Pretty good.
6, maybe? You have to have... This game caters to a very specific audience. Like, you gotta be really into this type of shit to really enjoy something like this. Like, heavily story-driven games where it's mostly just a movie.
Remember? It's just like a crown.
It's just like a crown. Look around. This game is like Detroit. Yeah, I've heard of that game, actually. Detroit Become Human. But I've never played it. Never played it. Also, I'm gonna say this now. Oh my God, it's the Green Goblin again. Please don't. He just pulls out a pumpkin bomb. He just throws it in her face. Well, he just gets on his glider and he's like, ha ha ha. He starts flying around. Oh yeah, this looks like a saw contraption. Yeah, it really does. Really does. But, this game is really weird. Can you tell why the top of your cranium will be splattered on a wall? Oh my God. Yeah, I can see that. Like, in a Saw movie. I wonder what happens if you shrug. Like, she just goes,
okay, let's start. Kathleen is...
Shrug. Oh, damn, I pressed... Yeah, sorry. Okay. Next time, I think it gives you a few times and to actually choose shrug. Tell us which one she just keep shrugging. Well, she just keeps going.
You think you can do that?
It's like, stop fucking shrugging. Wait. Okay, bro, this is like Saw. Yeah, it kind of is a little bit.
Alright, let's go for it.
This game is really...
First card.
I think it came out in 2013, I think. Two people. Oh, shit. So, yeah, this is like the ghost mode. Yeah, what's next? Battle it out? I don't know. But pretty much you're playing as a ghost, and this is where most of the game shines. She has this, like, psychic ability where she can, like, turn into a ghost. Kill the woman. Unfortunately, you can't kill her. You can only scare her. That's the only thing you can do. Wait, which one does she have? Oh, you have to match it, yeah. And then she has a star. Okay. So you say, aw. Yeah, it sucks. I don't think you can kill anybody. Wait, no, you can. I think there's a few people you kill in this game. I don't know, though.
Next card.
It's been a while since I played this game. It's a really strange game because controller prompts don't really show up too often. So you can never really tell when the game is in a cutscene or if it's an actual gameplay. Wait, sometimes she'll just be sitting there. I'm like, what the fuck? I'm like, oh, it's because I had to move.
Next card.
Okay. I am holding my winner. That's good to know, I guess. None of my business. That's the card I'm holding. Ah, the trump card. Let me see what you got there. I'm gonna fly inside of your boobies. I'm joking. The wiggle sign? I don't fucking know. The wiggles! Like that kid show. Oh god, very I need good, a swig Jordan. Of water.
Let's try something else. There's some building blocks on the table in the other room. I think you can make them fall over.
Yeah, so this is basically just a tutorial to show you how to play as Aiden, which Aiden is her dead brother. It is kind of a spoiler, but I mean, honestly, who the fuck cares? It's like, it's her dead brother. I think he died when he was in the womb still, but he like, lives on, I guess. But yeah, you have to scare this poor woman. Like, she's actually, like, you have to scare the shit out of her. It's actually kind of funny. But she's like, I'm a bitch. I'm too. Sick. Yeah, I mean, honestly, who wouldn't be scared of this, though? I mean, if that was me, I'd be shitting my pants, too, if I saw a bunch of shit fucking flying around. Hit nutty on an average Friday night. Yeah, sounds about right. It's a Friday night. Oh, is that her purse? It's like her money just goes flying everywhere. She's like, ah, fuck, and she has to pick it up. Oh, my God. Okay. What if he forgets to take schizophrenic pills? Yeah. I need to take my schizophrenia pills. It's like, wait. Miracle, what are you doing? No, I'm joking. No, we're not going to get into that.
Give us a moment.
Jesus. Say, oh, shit, change just fell out of my pocket. Yeah, it's just like, ah, shit.
You have to stop now, Joe.
Oh, my God. I need to bend over and pick it up. Well, I don't know about that. Oh, my God. He's not listening to me. She said, no, I didn't know. What was that face on him? She said, what the fuck? Oh my god. Hi, I'm Quagmire Giggity. Oh, Jesus. That's terrifying. You know, the cool thing, though, I gotta give them credit for is that as a child, they actually really managed to make her look like Ellen Page as a kid. Like, they actually did a pretty good job, but of course, Elliot Page didn't do the voice of the kid version. She only did the adult version. And my webcam froze again! Oh my god, OBS. Can you please not die for 5 seconds, please? Oh my god, OBS is the biggest shit biscuit I've ever had to deal with. Oh, what a pain in my ass, dude. Can I just go one stream? Okay, you look like you're doing devious things. You should have saw earlier, I was like, and my webcam was all frozen. But the cool thing is that it shows you the paths that other people took, which is kind of neat. It kind of shows you, like, which percentage of players you fit into. But, yeah, once again, I'm sorry about that. I don't know why fucking OBS is doing that. OBS is a piece of shit. Like, I think it's funny how people rave about how OBS is this great software. But it just is broken for me. Like, there's always something fucking wrong with it. Squid War. Making it always 2.0. Yeah, no, never. If I'm being totally honest with you guys, a second kid is something I never want to have, if I'm being honest. Because I realize dealing with a baby, from what I've had to deal with, is It's just something I don't want to deal with ever again, if I'm being honest. It's very stressful. So I realized, yeah, I think I'm done. I think I'm done being a parent. Well, not to, but you know what, for future kids, I'm not saying to my current kid. Yeah, I'm done being a parent. Good luck, kid. No, I'm joking. It's like, you don't have a father. Jesus. Mommy, I have a nightmare. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Sorry about my webcam freezing, guys. Seems like it's just going to continuously happen. What are you doing, hon? Just think about me and my brother. Oh, God. I mean, when I figured that out, though, at the end, I was like, holy shit, she has a brother? So that's what it is. Okay. I mean, why does she just have a ghost attached to her? Oh, this is perfect for the occasion. Look, holy shit. Merry fucking Christmas, everybody. Jesus, for those that do celebrate it. Does she really have toe socks? Are you fucking kidding me? Force her to stick her hand in the fire? Unfortunately, you cannot do that. You can only... I think it's funny, though. She'd be like, can I have a cookie? But you have to go in the garage or some shit. And then you get into a snowball fight, and then they get all pissed off. It's like, I mean, that's what kids do, right? They have snowball fights.
Can I have a cookie?
It's almost dinner time.
So oh my God, it's the buzzkill that says, no, you have to eat dinner first. If you're told your... If your brother told you to stick your hand in fire, would you? I don't know, I'll ask him. Oh God. It's like, hey, Aiden, what would you say? He's like, this is how you do it, sis. Oh shit, you can actually interact with the fire too. Hold on a sec. Wait a minute. What does it do though? That'd be funny if it made the house catch on fire though. I mean, I wouldn't be surprised though, because there's multiple pathways in each level. And the ending varies depending on what you do. I think this game has over 20 different endings. Like, 20 fucking endings, dude. Like, goddamn. I don't think I could do it. Like, 20 endings is a lot. And there's a trophy to get all the endings. Amazing. As a trophy hunter myself, that's a pain in the ass.
Where are you going?
Damn it. Can I have a cookie? No, you gotta eat your dinner first. That wasn't a question. That was a statement. Let me get my cookies, bitch. Oh my God. Jesus. I feel bad for the poor people that have to watch this, though. Like, they expect a streamer to take the game really seriously. And then they come in and they hear me saying, give me my cookies, bitch! And they're just like, yeah, I'm gonna leave. But I will say this, though. When it comes to story-driven games, I pay attention to cutscenes as much as I can. But I feel like if I stop talking, it kind of ruins the commentary, I guess. Like, some people, they have a pet peeve where if you talk over cutscenes, it's like, oh, I can't stand it, I'm leaving. In my case, it's like, I mean, if I don't keep up with the commentary, then I don't know. I mean, that's just me, though. I wish my sinuses didn't have a heart attack every 5 seconds. All right. What am I supposed to do? Oh, you have to go up to mommy? I like how she just taps her right there. Sometimes if you do stuff and you don't do it right away, it's very awkward. So it's like you'll just be walking around, then you just go tap her on the shoulder when you're supposed to do that earlier. Oh wow, Beyond Two Souls, my favorite moments later. Give me a cookie or I'll force your ass to stick your hand in the fire. Oh my God. I mean, there's a certain...
Honey, would you do me a favor? Could you get me a bottle of oil from the garage?
To be honest, you know who she looks like? She kind of looks like Tess from The Last of Us a little bit, kind of. Like, the way the mom looks, she kind of reminds me of Tess a little bit. But I mean, it's true though. I mean, there's a certain type of people where they expect the streamer to take it seriously, but with a game like this, I can't take it seriously at all. I thought she said, can you get me a bottle of lube from the garage? Oh my God. I mean, I wouldn't even be surprised. The kid just is innocent, doesn't know what lube is. It's like, okay, here you go, mommy. What the fuck is this? Poppy Playtime? Jeez. Slenderman the 8 pages? What a creepy garage. Whoa, was that a rat? Oh God, I'm scared, guys. What's gonna happen? What if I got jump scared and then my webcam just froze and I'm like, on the thing? Oh my God, that'd be funny. Mommy Milker's in the corner. What is that actually? Oh, we got a car in the garage. You want to go for a spin, baby? Oh my God. But I mean, if I would say though, I would recommend this game, but you have to have patience with something like this, because this game is by no means difficult at all. I would say if anything, this game is just... When I say patience, you gotta have patience for slow-paced gameplay. Like, you have to enjoy a type of game like this to play it, I guess. So something like Heavy Rain. Like, if you can tolerate shit like that, then you should be able to put up with this. I can force feed you motor oil by the spoonful. Oh my God. It's like, here you go, you little shit. Or If I give this to you, you give me a cookie, right?
Thanks, sweetheart.
She's like, fuck no. She just starts dumping her with gasoline. Oh my God. She starts running all over the house. Oh, God. Hey, sinuses, it'd be very nice if you didn't mess up on me every 5 seconds.
Hey, sweetheart. Why don't you go outside and play?
Oh, thank you. Okay. Dinner's ready. But there were a few instances in this game, though, where I would just walk around aimlessly for, like, minutes at a time, and I'm like, I don't know what the fuck to do. I don't know what to... Like, there's a level where you go into this, like, military base type place, and it's... I think it's, like, underwater or something like that. And, I remember I spent, like, 2 hours trying to figure out where the fuck to go. Like, it was so bad, I had to look up a video. I'm like, I don't know what the fuck to do. I'm confused. Nutty, where I blast off subscribers. I'm like, are we? The last time I checked, we're at 321, right? Oh, 3, 2, 1. Oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, 3, 2, 1, blast off. Buzz shit year. Oh, my God. Buzz good year. Yeah, 3, 2, 1, blast off. Buzz Lightyear has entered the chat. Yeah, that is pretty cool, though. I never noticed that. Because I was actually at 322, but someone unsubscribed. I don't know who it was. I guess somebody got bitter because I wasn't streaming. Which, that shit pisses me off. Like, Jesus, I'm sorry I have responsibilities. I'm sorry that I'm a dad now and I have a fucking kid to take care of. I am really sorry about that. Oh my God, the controls in this game are so fucking clunky. Get on the swing. What are you doing? Oh, Jesus. I don't even know why we bother putting up Christmas decorations, because half the time they just get knocked over. Every fucking time. I'm gonna go fucking reindeer outside. Fuck you, Mom. Okay, stay. Oh, wait a damn minute. What the fuck did you just say? Oh my God. Jesus. It's like, hey, Mom, I'm gonna go fucking reindeer outside. Oh, here we go. So, in order to get on the swing, you have to walk around aimlessly for 2 minutes. Oh yeah, you have to get behind in the pusher. That'd be creepy. Can you imagine seeing that? What if he pushed her so hard she just flew off? Okay, stay safe. I won't. Oh, jeez. Well, you gotta keep pushing her. What if she said, that's enough, Aiden? And then she just flies off. Well, she just does the GTA 4 ragdoll. Like a underdog. I wish you could pull an underdog in this. But I don't think you can, though. Yeah, it doesn't let me interact with it anymore. Shit. Well, that was really fucking amusing, wasn't it?
It's not fun anyway.
What a brat. I'm just... Fling the dumb bitch here. Oh my God. It's like she starts ragdolling like a GTA 4 character. I would lose my shit if this game had GTA 4 physics. Because GTA 4's ragdolls will never not be funny. Never not be funny. Like, that is... I think that's what defines that game. I mean, yeah, it has a good story and stuff.
Hey, did you hear that?
But GTA 4's ragdolls is one of the major highlights of that game. Jump in the snow pile. If it even lets me. Let me see what it does if I go up to it. Oh, you can't interact with it? That's stupid. Fuck's the point of it if I can't interact? It's like, yeah, let's just plop this snow pile here for no reason. Let's tease the player. Yeah, brother, help me. Oh, wait a minute. I need to suffocate. Oh my God. She's like, please, help me assist and kill. No, I'm not gonna say that. That's fucked up. Don't say that. Okay. I do know there's a hole in the fence that lets you go through it. Because you have to go pick a fucking fight with these kids or something. Who the fuck just called me a dummy? Oh, I'm not. Now I'm about to fuck somebody up. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't hold the X button for long enough. I'm sorry.
Jesus. Found a way to have some fun.
I don't even remember the last time I had a snowball fight. Probably when I was...
I know we're not supposed to.
12, maybe.
Just spend 5 minutes and come back. Mom will never know.
Oh, yeah, she will know. You little brat. I'm just... Brother, I know you died from an overdose on Lexapros, but help me kill me. Oh, my God. Jesus Christ, dude. Oh yeah, I forgot you have to do this with the controller. What are you doing? Oh my God, this game. It really utilizes the... Are you fucking kidding me? You didn't even try to climb the fence and you just fell on your ass. Really? Do better! No, I'm joking. Nutty school has dumb rules. Yeah, it really does. Who the fuck just called me a dummy?
Aiden, you're the best.
I'm the best until you later on you say you hate me. Did you see that shit? It's like she didn't even try to climb the fucking fence, though. It's like she barely pulled herself up and then fell backwards. Come on, you stupid... No, not that's it. That kid looks ugly as hell. Also, I will say this, though. The black borders is something that you cannot disable. Because it's meant to make... Okay, look at this shit. Tell me this isn't creepy. It's like she has fucking aimbot. It's like she doesn't even have to, like, face towards him to hit him. It's actually funny. It's like she just has aimbot. Look at that shit. She went like that with the fucking snowball. Oh my God. Damn, fucking Jody Holmes has fucking aimbot. You're not allowed to touch snow. I just went fuck off and just put ice down my friend's back and melted it. Oh yeah, I hate when people do that shit. Oh god, I can get that feeling in my back right now. Jody has aimbot confirmed. It reminds me of that port in the West was too, actually, a little bit. Kinda.
She said, hehe. She's like, I got aimbot, bitch.
What up?
Look at that, look! She wasn't even facing the right direction when she hit him with it! This game has no logic! No, I'm just...
Oh, I actually missed.
I got you!
No, I got me!
Whoa. What's going on here? No, I'm just... Oh, she put snow in his face. That kid is ugly as hell. He looks like Chucky. What the fuck? He's like, you can't see me. He's doing the John Cena thing. Oh, he started choking the kid, yeah. Damn. Violence, kids. What if he actually killed him, though? Wait, did he die? I do know there's a part where you're at a birthday party when she's like, I think, 16, 17 or something like that. But there's one part in this game that is so cringeworthy, though.
She's a witch! A dirty, rotten witch!
Oh, wow. And this is the same guy that fucking tackled me to the ground for no reason.
Jody Holmes is a witch!
And you're an asshole. That's what I would say. Jody Holmes is a witch! And I'd say, and you're a bitch. A witch!
Get in the house!
Whoa. Abusive parents right there. Too bad your mom is a bitch. Oh, jeez.
You know you're not allowed to leave the yard!
I saw the other kids playing. I just wanted to have some fun.
What did you do to that boy?
Philip.
What did you do to that boy? What'd he say? Like,
I'm okay. Sick and tired of your stories. Jody, this time you're really gonna get it.
Oh my god, Jesus Christ. Jody, this time you're really gonna get it. Oh, jeez. That shows a lot about his character, right? He's, I am sick of your stories.
No!
He said, no! I wish he would grit his teeth when he said that. Oh my god, his test from the West was... Oh jeez, beat the shit out of me and I'll beat the shit out of you. Fair enough, yeah. I feel bad though, because it's like, she gets the impression that her parents don't love her. And you know what the funniest part is that these aren't even her fucking real parents. Like, they're her adoptive parents. Hot Pocket, the fuck?
Mommy.
Yeah, Hot Pockets are okay, I guess. They really don't even have much taste. What the fuck is this chat? I don't even know, dude. I feel bad for the poor soul that finds this stream, though. It's like, oh, nice, an in-depth playthrough of Beyond Two Souls. And then they come in here and they're like, what the fuck is this? Oh my goodness. Now go to sleep. Or Santa Claus won't come, you little shit. But under normal circumstances, this part of the game would actually not take place. Like, if you do an original playthrough of this in the out-of-order events...
It's your fault my parents don't let me. You hear me? Go away!
Damn. No, but, if you play this under normal circumstances, this part is actually not till like 50% of the game. Mom, there's a monster in my closet. No, sweetie, that's your uncle. Oh my god. Jesus Christ. Secret tickle time. Is that what you're gonna say?
That's a monster.
You can't talk about her like that.
The things that are happening around her, they're not normal. And they're getting stronger, for the love of God, Susan. What's the problem?
He said, for the love of God, Susan. What'd he say like that? But I will say this, though. The cutscenes don't really bug me that much. Because, I've beaten this game a few times already. He's eating a big plate of fuck all. Oh my god. Yeah, like, he just has an empty plate right there. Doesn't really make much sense.
Crazy.
Oh, jeez, I thought I could see her ribcage. I'm like, what the fuck? Honest to god, she looks like a baby doll just laying in the fucking... Like, you know when baby dolls just lay there? Like, you just throw them somewhere? Oh my god. I think you just have to keep harassing her. Oh my god, that just went entirely out of context. I think you just have to keep harassing her. Say, what the fuck? Huh? You're just about to, I don't know. I can't really say that, I can't base it off the tag, I don't really know. Alright. I don't know what to do. See, this is an instance where you get stuck. I think you just have to keep messing with her, though. Again, that could be taken entirely out of context. Uncle Dingle playing the closet. Oh my god. Jesus. It's like, Uncle Dingle, stop it, tickles. What have I become? Some kind of monster? Oh, Jesus criminy. Yeah, but I'm really sorry about ending the previous stream, though. I actually had to do it because as soon as I started my stream, I didn't realize that OBS wasn't detecting my microphone, so I was like, ah, fuck, I have to do it. I guess you could call him a minion since he has his banana. Oh, Jesus. This is me every time I go to bed. Seriously. Toss and turn. What are we? Dorian tip? Huh? Dorian rip? Well, Dorian's actually not here. I'm sure he'll probably join later, though. He's usually one of the last ones to show up in the chat. But there's instances where he will show up, though, like, pretty early. I don't know, one time he showed up, like, maybe 30 minutes into the stream. I'm like, damn. That's pretty early, but usually he shows up, like, 1 to 2 hours in. He's banished. Oh, jeez. He's banished from the Shadow Realm. Or to the Shadow Realm, that is. Okay. What's up, Luke? How you doing, man? He said, hi, guys.
I'm playing as a little girl with a dolly.
What in the fuck is that thing? That thing is creepy. Oh my god, look at the eyes.
It's like, die, you little shit.
That's what the little rabbit looks like it's gonna say. Aw, you gotta hug your little teddy bear. This game has you doing some weird shit, though. I mean, I don't know the one part. It's like you actually, when you make dinner, it's like you have to, like, actually spin the stick to make her, like, stir the food and shit. And I'm playing as Uncle Dingle. Oh my god, she's... Ah! She was getting dragged out of the bed. Oh my god. Forgive me, guys. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. That wasn't funny. I'm sorry. That wasn't funny. That's Spooderman. Oh, jeez. That's not the only teddy bear she'll be pointing on. Oh, god. I hope it is. Damn, she looks fucking traumatized. Jeez. Oh, wait. Hold on a second. Wait, Miracle, are you in the chat right now? I didn't even see your comment. Miracle, if you want to comment something, you should do. Mr. Stream, it's been 12 years. 12 years? Huh? I mean, I'm glad you're missing the streams, but it's just, you know, I have a daughter and stuff, and I'm a pretty stressful life, so it's, I haven't really had the time to stream, but I'm trying to stay consistent with it, though. America has Spider-Man, but Germany has Spider-Man. Cut it out. It's my fault. I did what? What the fuck did you say? What? I'm just, it's not going in her face. Is that her jacket? Oh, wow. So, like I said, this is being played in chronological order. So, you start when she's a kid, and then by the end, you play as an adult. It's been 2 years, Daddy. I really miss you. Quandale Dingle not being weird. Where the fuck did she... She wasn't even there before. What is she? Fucking Goku? Instant transmission shit? That's creepy. Oh, my God. Jesus. Oh, I remember this part. It actually kind of makes me laugh, because... Is he a ghost? I don't know. It's just the way he said it. Is he a ghost? And yes, Niall, if you're wondering, you can shrug on that part, I think.
She's a ghost.
Or her brother's a ghost, actually. All right, how do I do this? Oh, you have to... All right, I got it. I was just flying around for no reason, like a jackass. All right. Let's go into the principal's office. I broke the rules.
Hello, Daddy.
I'm getting expelled. I'm joking.
My name is Nathan.
She knows Song was actually based on a murderer.
Huh? I thought it would be a good idea for us to have a little...
Holy fucking shit, guys. It's the Green Goblin. He's back from the dead to kill us all. No, I'm joking. He's just like, can the Spider-Man come out to play? No, I'm joking. Jojo always has... Stawa Power? Pausing time? Are you talking about JoJo's Bizarre Adventure? That's like the only thing I can think of when that comes to mind. Because I used to have a viewer, well, not used to, but I still do have a viewer in here that likes JoJo. I wouldn't even be surprised if he shows up when he's like, JoJo, what? Okay. It's too late, Spider-Man. We'd have been legalized. What the fuck?
Can the Spider-Man come out to play?
But I'm gonna be right back. Gotta take a piss. Oh, yeah, you're fine, dude. Go ahead. Take your time. Understand.
Jody, my job is to study strange events.
That would actually be a cool job, to be honest. Like, to study, like, paranormal shit. I think I could do something like that.
Like the things that happen around you, right, Jody?
Yeah, but honestly, I'm probably going to talk over this. I guess, shrug. See, that reminds me of Miracle. Whenever I'm talking about GTA with her, she just kind of goes... Well, she just kind of shrugs, so she doesn't really know what to say. Oh, my God. Queen Goblin. Oh, God.
His friend, has he been with you a long time?
Yes. I guess she just goes...
You were born.
I'm going to say shrug. I mean, honestly, who the hell remembers being born, though? I mean, nobody really remembers that shit.
Is he a ghost?
Is he a ghost? I don't know. It's just the way he says it.
Oh my god. It's not really meant to be funny, but I guess shrug. I mean, what kind of kid is gonna know if it's a ghost?
Can you draw him for me?
Sure, I can draw you a fucking grade A Mona Lisa level shit. Oh, hi, Miracle. She said hi. I didn't see her comment. The hell? Oh, I didn't even get a chance. If you don't make a decision in time, the game does it for you. Hey, Miracle, I'm playing as your most favorite person ever of all time. I'm playing as Elliot Page. I'm back. What's up now? Miracle. Oh, God, it's like baby talk. What the fuck? Yeah, she just draws a bunch of scribbles. Love you, babe. I love you. Hey, Miracle, how are you? Heard what happened. Not going to go into detail about it, but how are you? Yeah, we're not really going to talk about that here. But she's doing good, though. She's doing good. It's like you actually have to interact with it. There's a part in this game where she makes food or something. It's like when she stirs the pot, you actually, like, have to do something for her to, like, twirl the thing. She drew a fucking a stick figure with a black blob attached to him. Ellen Page. Or Elliot Page, that is. Yes, I'm good. Oh, what are you drawing? The ghost again. Oh my god, holy shit. No, I'm not even gonna say that, dude. Oh, a big black dictionary, I was about to say. if just look at that. You know what that looks like? An umbilical cord. That's what it looks like. Like, it... It's the way he said it. You guys probably didn't catch it because I was talking too much. But he was like, he's connected to some sort of cord. I don't know, it's just the way he said it. Like, hey, yo, that's wasist. Fuck baby talk. I need to pay attention to that one. Oh my god. The choices that you make throughout the game, it determines the ending. There's over 20 different endings. But I do know at the end, you can either choose life or death. And if you choose to die, I think she... kind of, she becomes the next Aiden, if you guys get my drift. Like, there's a character in this game that gets pregnant, and she has a baby. And then that baby has powers, just like she does, and then Jody is the next, like, Aiden character. Like, she's the next ghost, if you know what I'm saying. But, no, she's just drawing a big black dictionary cat. Oh, Jesus. What am I supposed to do? Oh, you're supposed to call him. Yeah. See, I need to pay attention to dialogue. What am I doing? Nutty Ape. But if you choose life, I think she lives a peaceful life with Aiden, I think. Or when he departs or something like that, and then she lives a normal life.
And it happens.
Yeah, that's what happened, yeah.
I don't tell Aiden what to do. No one does. He's like a lion in a cage. We're tied together. He can't go away. That makes him really angry. It's not my fault. I want him to leave too. It can be really scary sometimes.
Well, yeah, I mean, I'd be scared if some fucking paranormal entity was fucking my life up like that. Well, Jesus, that's nice to see on a child. Nutty Ape, cat, Pigsy Angry, oh, Jesus. Let's not get manhunted here. Oh, my God. Miracle Abel has joined the chat. Why did I just say that? I wasn't even, I don't know why, at least it's because I looked at her name right there. Erotic excruciation. Oh, Jesus. So if you guys can see, that this thing right here is pretty cool because it tells you the percentage of players that took the same path as you, which is kind of cool. So 77% of the people drew Aiden, which means that it's possible not to draw him. And then there's another path that you can take where you don't show his powers. My last name isn't Abel. Well, Jesus, woman, I'm sorry. The brother can do that. Yeah, that, oh yeah, yeah, that, I see what you're saying. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, it's Turpin. Yeah, your last name is Turnip. Yeah. All I am is a man. I want the world in my hands.
Just long enough for them to find out what's going on.
Oh my
Please
god.
Please don't leave me here.
Just for a couple of days.
Couple of days, my ass. I mean, a couple of fucking years. Because she's still here when she's a teenager. Oh, excuse me, guys. I'm sorry. Like on YouTube. That really looks like Tess from The Last of Us. Rip Tess. Why is she hugging her? Like, she don't even give a damn. Well, she's just kind of like, she just doesn't know what the fuck she's doing. But imagine Green Goblin shows up. He is. He's right there. He's standing right there. He just doesn't have his fucking pumpkin bombs and shit. Oh, what's up, Jaden? How you doing, man? How you doing, mate? Jeez. I just picked up a new instrument. Thought I could get bitches in year 7. Turns out nobody gives a fuck. Damn. Sad story. I'm just That's a sad story right there, man. Okay, knock on wood. But the webcam has not frozen in a while. Hopefully that doesn't happen again.
But here we have a better chance of understanding what's happening.
What if he just says, oh my god, what if he says that thing he said to Spider-Man? What was that fucking thing he said?
Nobody can protect me.
He just says to Jody, he's just like, misery, 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 that's what you've chosen. He's like, I offered you friendship, and you spat in my face, and he just starts punching the fuck out of her. I love what he said. Instead of saying piss, or spit, I said piss. Instead of saying spit, he says spat. What the fuck?
Okay.
But, Jane, I can't tell what your profile picture is, left by myself. What time are you going to be here tomorrow? I'm not sure. I haven't fully decided yet. I'll let you know, though. But, cool. Damn, she's fucked up. Looks depressed. If I hear a kid says, ooh, it's that green guy from Fortnite, I'm going to throw that kid on the bed. Oh, yeah, the Burj Khalifa. That's the tallest building in the world, ain't it? Okay.
All right.
But that'd be funny as fuck, though. He's just like, I offered you friendship, and you spat in my face. He just starts beating the fuck out of her. Yeah. On. Huh? What? Look at this old computer. Wait, where the fuck is the tower, though? Oh, is it? Oh, it's on top of the... Oh, yeah. It's already beneath it. You throw him upwards on the Burj Khalifa. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I see. Oh, yeah. You'd have to throw him up there first before you can get him on there. Oh, shit. There's a symbol on the wall. If later on, there's a poster right there. And it looks exactly like the Uzumaki symbol. Wow. Jesus. Speaking of which, I just heard that downstairs, actually. A baby fucking screaming, probably for no good reason. There will be a day when the sun will go up on the opposite way. That's not good. I'm assuming... Oh, yeah, you have to go in here and change your clothes, I guess.
Hope they haven't put cameras in here, too.
Damn, that was a quick change, jeez. She said boop boop and was done that quick. I think you just go to sleep right after this. Yeah, you just go right to sleep. You see the way she jumped on the bed? It's like she just jumped like, she was like, woo! Oh my god. The ghost helped her. Probably, I wouldn't even be surprised. There will be a day where all furries will be sniped with a 50 caliber sniper rifle. Sounds about right. Oh my god, are you fucking kidding me? I can't sleep without my teddy bear. Really, kid? Come on, we got bigger shit to worry about. We got much bigger shit. We gotta study why you have a fucking ghost on your inside of your body. Who the fuck cares about that damn teddy bear? We gotta get it, because she'll curse up a storm if we don't. It's just like 2 hours later, she's like, fucking throwing a fit on the bed and shit. Well, play coolmathgames.com on the computer from 1989. Oh, Jesus. You know what's funny? The computer you can't even interact with, I don't think. This game is very limited with the gameplay. Like, you can't really do much in this game. You can just kind of move from point A to point B. But that's about it. Other than that, you really can't do much in this game. Like, it's not like GTA where you can steal cars and fly choppers. Like, you can just move where the game lets you move. You have a ghost problem, but you put that aside and get the teddy bear, yeah. It's like, that's our top priority. Get this kid a teddy bear. Oh my goodness. I swear to God, I'm going to cut my nose off on stream, and I'm going to mail you guys a screenshot of it.
I'm going to turn out the light now. Good night, Jody.
Wait.
That would just be creepy. I mean, can you imagine trying to sleep and there's people monitoring you the whole time? That's creepy.
I don't like it when it's dark.
Oh, poor baby. You don't like it when it's dark. Oh, it's Ted Bundy, no teddy bear. I mean, Ted Bundy? Or Ted Bunny? That's not creepy. I mean, some people were scared of the dark. I mean, to be honest, I do have a sort of small fear of the dark a little bit at times.
We're gonna have a good night's sleep.
Like, when it's pitch black, it kind of makes me unnerved a little bit. I love the unnecessary swearing in Spider-Man when he just said I should have... Oh, yeah, that was funny as fuck. I remember that. I should have fucked your little girlfriend. Dude, that was so fucking funny, too. Oh, my God, I love that part. That part had me rolling in that chill stream. Jesus. This is me when I go to sleep, toss and turn.
I can't sleep, Aiden. I think I need a story.
You literally lay down for 5 seconds. What do you mean you can't sleep? She waited for 5 seconds, turned over, and said, I can't sleep. You didn't even try. That one piece of clothing when you turn off the light. Whoa. Yeah, don't say that. What is this, a flashlight? Is that a nightlight? To be honest, I'm not going to say it. I don't want to get demonetized. Or I'm not even monetized to begin with, but I'm still not going to say it just for... Nutty fuckers with girlfriend of the chick. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, no, we're not gonna get into that. That's nobody's business. But, I mean, that's how everybody got here, to be honest. Wait, is that floating? Oh my god, it reminds me of those Call of Duty glitches. Like, whenever an object is floating. Is that the thing that begins with D and ends with... No, it's... Oh my god! What the fuck is going on? Dude, I'm just sitting there. She's just in the fucking air float. What the fuck was that, dude? What am I supposed to be doing? Throw the... That wasn't even me that did that, though. What the fuck was that? Oh, she just cannot catch a break. Jesus. Now I swear to God. Oh, you better watch out. Miracle's wrath is coming. You better watch out, dude. Jesus. You turn your back. Yeah, I did. And then she's just in the fucking air. There's like these evil spirits or something. They attack her. Oh my god. They said, nope, you're not escaping. Come back here. Oh, shit. What is she dead? What the fuck? Jesus, can you imagine something like that happening to you, though? I can't even imagine that. That'd be scary. I mean, like, you're trying to fucking sleep and it just happened again. Come back to the bedroom. Yeah, pretty much. That's what it feels like. Oh my god, this is a fucking nightmare, dude. This is hell on earth. I don't think it... I can't imagine because I put salt around my bed. Wait. I can't even tell what the fuck is going on right now. There's this big black thing opening its mouth. It looks like a spider, kinda. Oh my god, that is... This poor little kid has to fuck... I didn't kill it, dude. What are you doing? Oh my god, what was that? I like how I just hear... Ah! And then I just hear a fucking loud-ass clash. Oh my god. You really think you're gonna... Oh my god. There's a big black thing opening its mouth. Yeah, we're... No. Dude, I didn't kill it. You fucking idiot. You guys probably... Can you guys hear me okay? When I talk over the game? If the game is a bit loud, I can turn it down. Just let me know, guys. Because this game actually doesn't have any kind of audio settings, which is really strange to me. Oh, jeez. Holy shit. It's okay. Oh, okay. Cool. Because if it was too loud, I would have had to turn it down. Jeez. I want to make sure the game is audible. This poor kid, she just cannot catch a break. But Miracle probably likes it because she hates Elliot Page. Which I don't understand why she does. I actually like Elliot Page. He's pretty good, I should say. Uncle Dingle isn't finished with her yet. Yeah, he's not done yet. I feel like Cameron's going to come in here when we're talking about this. And he's just going to be like, okay. Oh my god. What a fucking shit show. You going to pay for that? Are you gonna pay for that? Hey, big black thing, are you gonna pay for that? My god, you flip the f- And she just lays there. Hurry! Oh my god. But there's a part of this game, though, that's extremely cringeworthy. Where she's like a teenager, but she's a rebellious teenager. And she's like all gothic and shit, and she's like, oh, that's not fair, I want to go to that party. It's very cringeworthy. It is very cringeworthy. Like, I mean, I like this game, but there's a few parts where it's just like, you know, it's just weird. Pay for what you have done on Parish or Parish into the Soul World. Oh, yeah. Jesus. So, it's possible to spy on Dawkins. It's possible for Cole to wake up alone or not wake up alone. You vanquish. So, it's possible to actually fail that part. But then again, though, there's really no way to die in this game. Like, there's no way to really die in this game. Like, there's no failure, I guess. There's no failure system. There's no health meter. There's no mission structure. It's just kind of like, you just kind of play it, I guess. So basically, this is one of the few games I've played where it's impossible to die. Just gives you a different outcome.
Right. We've been transferred. We have to leave the base.
No, please don't leave me. Oh my god. But the goal tonight is, because I never played this in chronological order, but I would say the goal tonight is to at least get to the FBI training or the CIA, whatever the fuck it is she joins. That's the goal tonight, is get that far. Damn my sinuses. I like that pillow, though. Looks like a comfy room. Unless a big black thing comes out of nowhere and throws me off my bed.
Okay.
Hey, Green Goblin. It actually kind of looks like him in the movie, too. Like, if you remove the glasses, he looks just like Norman Osborn. Oh, my God. Jesus Christ. Jesus, he's like, you know how much I sacrificed? I remember that part. That man about lost his shit. Yeah, see right there? That looks just like the Uzumaki symbol from Naruto. Yeah, fight me, Spider-Man. Oh, Jesus. I remember that part when he was on the rooftop with him. He's like, you're an amazing creature, Spider-Man. He's like, you and I are not so different. God. This man really tried to say, he really tried to team up with Spider-Man. And Spider-Man's just like,
give me a minute,
Phil. Nah, I'm good. There was a big black thing that threw me off the bed. None of you are extra sussy. I mean, what do you want me to call it? Black blob? Like, what the fuck do you want me to say? It was a big black thing. It was a thing that... A big black thing! I mean, I don't know what you want me to say. Like, this black spirit calling Venom. And that's what... It did look kind of like Venom a little bit. Jesus. Hold on a second. Wait, I can interact with the stepmom? It was a big black thing. I mean, that's the best way to put it. I don't know what you want me to call it. Like, a big black thing. That's like the only thing I can say. Okay. You could say another spirit. Yeah, that's true. A black spirit? How about that? I swear to God, I'm going to lose my mind with my sinuses. But as for the stream tomorrow, I'm not sure if I'm going to be streaming. I haven't fully decided just yet. But more than likely, I just haven't decided. But definitely on Sunday, though. Because I'm trying to keep it consistent. Because as of late, I've just kind of been streaming whenever I can, but that's about it. What's wrong with white spirits, huh? A lot. I have a problem with white spirits. Do you have a problem with that? I don't know, Walter. You what kind of sus?
Listen, I'm not sure.
All right, so this is the first instance where Elliot Page is actually voicing the character.
Maybe I shouldn't go.
So this is when she's like a tween, I guess. Maybe like 14 or something. I don't know. A stepmom? Yeah, it's her... Not her stepmom, but it's her foster mom, I think. That's like the best way I can think of it. It's like her adoptive parents or some shit. Like, that's not her actual biological mom. Stepbro? Okay, whoa. Let's not go there.
There's no reason to panic. It's just a birthday party. I'm sure everybody will like you.
The Green Goblin in this game, he's so nice. Like, and then he fucking went insane, and then he became a goblin that flies on a glider and tries to blow people up. Oh my God, he really did Spider-Man dirty in that part. He not only did he throw him through a fucking abandoned building, but then on top of that, he threw a grenade as a fucking slap in the face, like just disrespect. He's like, okay, you want to be like that? I just got Spider-Man. What difficulty should I use? Friendly or amazing?
It's gonna be all right.
You want me to be honest with you? It doesn't make a difference. Like, cause I beat that game on the hardest difficulty.
I'll pick you up at five.
It feels the same on each difficulty. The only difference is that you lose more health, I guess. Like, you take more damage. But it's actually, like, since it's your first time playing, just go for friendly, I guess. But that game is actually piss easy on the easy or the hard difficulty. You have 68 counts of sexual harassment. Want to make it to 69? Sure, why not? Why not? And also, while I'm at it, why don't I just blow my nose, too? Because I'm getting really sick of my fucking sinuses. Hold on, guys. Hold on. Oh. Great. I dropped my fucking headphones. I'll be right back. My sinuses suck. And now I look like a ghost. Now I look like a ghost. Jeez. Oh my God. Nutty bending over. Oh, he's grabbing the tissues. I have to. I don't know why. I think the funniest part is that every time I start my stream, that's when my sinuses decide to just go, eh. But then when it's over, it goes like, like it just acts like nothing happened. Motherfucker sound like an F1 race car. Oh my God. Yeah, when I blew my nose. Oh, Jesus. Had to get it out. I feel bad for her in this part, though, because they, they invite her over just to fuck with her. Like, they're not actually her friends. I hate people like that. And there's that fucking little cubby hole right there where Harry Potter was. Oh my God. Didn't they did him dirty too. They had him fucking living under there.
Everyone.
Oh my God, look, it's me. Okay, look, there's a guy in this part where he looks exactly like me. Like, he actually looks like me, to be honest. That guy right there! Holy shit.
Stuff like that?
Oh god, he even has my voice too. He said, stuff like that? Shift gears. The way Elliot walks. And you know what's funny? That's how he actually walks in real life too. Like, he kind of walks like with this. Like, I can't really describe. It's kind of like a really kind of just, I guess, I don't know, like a very carefree type walk. Like, kind of just like, I don't give a shit about anything type. Like, that's how she, like, in the movie Juno, he walks exactly like that. Just gay. Well, I mean, that's the thing about Elliot. When they were formerly known as Ellen Page, they came out as gay. And then in December 2020, I think, then that's when that whole transgender shit started. It's like, yep, I am Elliot Page now. I'm not Ellen Page. And you know the scary part? Is that his voice is a lot deeper now. It's kind of creepy, actually. It's like, whenever he talks now, it's like an empty shell of what it used to be. It's kind of creepy. Like, it sounds the same, it's just deeper. Ooh, this tunes, yeah.
Even go into my room anymore.
Ah, you interrupted my vibe. That fucking asshole. He even has my voice. Jeez, he's a genius. Well, he has that deep ass voice.
Yeah, cool, sure.
Yeah, it's cool to drink, guys, yeah. Just because others do it, that means you have to do it. She's not even going to drink it, is she? Look at that fucking necklace she has on. Oh my god. This movie, I meant to say game. I mean, you could really call this a movie. This could easily be a movie. Oh my god. Spider-Man game for PS4. Yeah, it's a great game, actually. And they're making a sequel, too. It comes out, I think, fall next year. And it's called, I think it's just called Spider-Man 2, I think. But it has Peter Parker and Miles Morales. Hey, babe, you want to make that 68? Whoa! Miracle, I don't think we should be talking about that. Hey, yo, yeah, that's what I'm saying. She just sits down and then gets back up. That's my job. What? Excuse me? Who said that was your job? Oh my god. See, this is how I am at parties, like big social events. I kind of just exclude myself from it. I don't really like talk to people or anything or dance or anything like that.
Hi, I'm Matt. Jody, right?
Get out of my way, you fucking asshole. He's like, hi, I'm Matt.
I've seen you at school before.
This guy looks like the biggest douchebag ever. I don't know. I'll just say reserved.
I'm in a different program with my own teacher.
With my own teacher? What'd she say? Like, Jesus. Nutty said that with excitement at the end.
So you work with Kirsten's mother?
Wait, is he fucking Australia or something?
I've met Kirsten before.
BS. Sus.
My mom works in my unit. That's why I was invited.
I used to live in London before I'm...
Oh, he's from London. Okay, so we got somebody from the UK here. Holy shit. Now, is that you? I'm gonna lie.
New York?
New York, my ass. You ain't from NYC. You ain't from Liberty City.
I went there once. It blew me away. Do you have any hobbies? Anything you do for, like, fun?
I can't tell if he's...
I surf any chance I get, and I play in a band with a...
Yeah, he has an accent. I was about to say, I can't really tell if he has an accent.
What are you into?
Just be reserved. I feel like reserved would be the canon option because, I mean, I feel like somebody would like that would be. Boring. That's my job. Whoa, huh?
Don't talk about that here.
No, I'm joking. That's our business.
Why are you in unit 4?
Why are you in my face? Leave me alone.
I'd rather not talk about it.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
Damn, I'm so stupid. I hope I haven't, like, upset you or anything.
Thought these were DMs. Yeah, dude, delete the messages right now. No, I'm joking. And look, you can see me in the background at the fucking counter table.
Are you up for it?
I'm just gonna accept it.
Sure.
Wow, she got balls. I'm joking. She actually has balls. She doesn't have... No, I'm joking. Not gonna get into that. Damn, my fucking nose. I hate my sinuses. Oh, fuck. God. Jesus. You know who he actually sounds like, kinda? He kinda sounds like Chris Hemsworth a little bit. Like the guy that plays Thor from the MCU movies. Which, speaking of which, I like his Thor. I think he does a great job as Thor. But I've actually heard he actually is developing dementia, I think. Which is crazy, because he's not even old. He's not even that old.
I'm sure you hear this all the time, but...
Big truck exploded really this game. Pretty, you know? Oh, yeah, that's at the beginning, yeah. I remember that part. I'm just going to say ironic.
Do you say that to all the girls you meet?
girls, you mean boys, Elliot. What the fuck are you talking about? You shouldn't be saying girls, you're a boy. Something special about this game doesn't make any fucking sense, I'm turning it off! No, I'm just... distant.
Thanks. You don't really know me.
Damn, she said, you don't really know me. She's like, you know, whoa, hey. I'm gonna move his hands. Yeah, keep him up there. Yeah, there you go, you fucking pervert. Should I kiss him? I'm just gonna move away. What the fuck?
Thanks for the dance, Matt.
I do know that I did kiss him, though, on my one playthrough. Like, I allowed him to make advances, but... that's just weird. Like, aren't they, like, 15, 16 or something
guys,
like that?
Guys, why doesn't Jody give us a demonstration of her super mega powers?
Oh my god. No. You saw nothing.
I'd pay to see that. Ugh, forget.
This guy looks like me and sounds like me. Isn't that scary? He's like, yeah, I'd love to see that. I like the way his voice sounds. He's got a deep-ass voice. I'm just gonna refuse.
No, I don't have anything to show.
I told you so, guys. It's all bullshit.
They all, honest to God, you know what they look like? They all look like Sims characters. What the hell? Hey, guys. Jesus. Niall's just like, I'm gonna go pink now instead of blue. Jesus, Niall was timed out by Niall. It does some shit. Wow.
Love, Jen, XXX. Aw, that's nice, babe. I bet it's knee socks.
What the hell? I guess she's a lesbian. Are you fucking kidding? Really? They all look like Sims characters. Honestly, is this the Sims 5 gameplay? Holy shit. Babe, can you text me after? Yeah, I got you. Don't you worry one bit. She gets her a book, but she acts ungrateful. She's like, oh, I got a book. Like, be grateful you get fucking anything, you ingrate. Like, what the fuck did you expect? A new car? Like a book. Be grateful you got shit, asshole. But Nutty, read your DMs. We got some important biz when you talk about. I got you, bro.
It's a really rare collection. Poems by Edgar Allan Poe.
Oh, Miracle loves Edgar Allan Poe.
Did you steal this from your grandpa's library?
No.
Hey, you fucking asshole. I would have been like, excuse me? No, did I steal it from your mom's fucking sex toy drawer? I should have said that. Jesus.
No, but seriously, is this a joke? I can't believe you came all the way to my birthday party just to give me this old crap.
Oh my god. I hate people like that. Like, in real life, I want to punch people like that. Just fucking ingrates. I hate people like that.
And you think she's like,
be grateful you got shit. You got anything. Be grateful that you got anything. We got some packages we need to move, if you know what I mean.
Around like a puppy all evening.
Oh, yeah. I'm joking.
Oh. And she's a slut, too.
What? Oh, no, now you're doing... What the fuck, just...
Yeah, she's a slut. A slut in a...
Oh my god, he even has my nose. Miracle, tell me that guy doesn't look like me.
What do you do with witches?
That guy actually looks like me, and that's terrifying. Wait a minute. I wonder if that is a reference to that one movie Ellen Page was in. Because they just burned her with a cigarette. And, there's a movie she was in where she got burned with a cigarette like that. There's a half-black package I want. Miracle. What is this, Harry Potter? They just shove her in that little cubby hole.
Please let me
what the hell?
Out.
And yes, that dude looks like...
Please let me out.
Elliot, ain't that serious?
Please.
Did someone say Kay?
Please, I want
to
get...
Oh, because she just she just keeps going... Like, she just keeps hitting it, like... My god, apparently this is fucking Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone, whatever it is. I'm not a Harry Potter guy. Mash X. Well, that's the thing, I was hitting X, but it just wasn't doing nothing. I hit triangle, she just kept going... Oh, she just kept... Hit. Yeah. Harry Potter and the Gas Chamber, oh my god, Jesus. Is that the newest one that just came out? I'm joking. It should be called Hitler Potter, the Gas Chamber. I mean, and the Chamber, 1942. Harry Potter's biggest enemy yet. A Nazi concentration camp. Oh my goodness. Oh, I have to switch to Aiden, yeah. Wait, what, do I have to sit here and watch her cry? Jesus. There you go. Oh, it's time to get revenge on these fuckers. Now, the crazy thing is that it's possible to burn the house down, but I don't know how to do it, though. That's one of the, I guess, scenarios you can do. I think you have to do something to make the... Oh, wait, no, I know how to do it. You have to, like, knock something over for the house to catch fire. Harry Potter's biggest flaw being a Jew. Oh my god, Jesus Christ. Hitler wasn't very happy about this news. He invited Harry to, Hogwarts concentration camp. And he said, to the gas chamber you go. Oh my god, I'm going to hell. Grab the knife. I think you can, I think. It's been a while since I played this game, though. But I love this part because you get to fuck with these people. Especially this one. Well, that little motherfucker.
You came all the way to my party just to give me a book?
Yeah, bitch, I did. I gave you... Be grateful you got anything. Except you're a Jew, Harry. I'm a what? A Jew?
Oh, what do you know? You're a Jew, Harry!
Instead of a wizard. Oh my goodness. Yeah, Hitler would be Voldemort, I guess. Enough is enough. Let's not talk about Adolf Hitler. That was a piece of shit. It's not that. I'm gonna tell you guys something funny. There's a guy I used to watch on YouTube, and his name was The Stimpy Land, I think.
That's crazy. I'm getting out of here.
Bye, see ya. Anybody gonna miss you?
Wait for me.
I like how they're just watching football. Happy birthday, nah, more like happy death day. Yeah, pretty much. I love this part right here because you get to exact revenge on these fuckers. Because in real life, I'm a vengeful person, so yeah, this is the best approach. But it's possible not to attack them, though. It's possible to burn the house down, which I think I've done it before. Damn, hear that music? Why am I trying to open the window? Yeah, that's probably something I would try to do in real life, actually. Damn, knocked her ass over. That's the one they called me a slut, too. Yeah, I'm gonna try to burn the house down. I just forget, you have to knock something over. These guys are fucking idiots. I like how they're dialing 911, like as if the police are gonna be able to do something about this. What the fuck? Like, the police ain't gonna be able to do shit. Oh, I can't wait to do this. What a fucking ingrate, that's what you get.
She said.
What, you got hit with that little bottle of pop? Like, Master Nutty teaches the way of being arsonistic? Oh my god. Yeah, we're about to commit arson in this fucking bitch.
After the shit they did to me.
Do you guys think when somebody shoots up a school, this is the music that goes to their head? Like that music of exacting revenge? No, I'm joking. This is quite the soundtrack here, but it sounds pretty good, I'm not gonna lie. I'd be banging all the pots and pans in the kitchen. Yeah, me too, actually. Oh, damn, I just fucked myself up, jeez. I like how he was kicking his legs like that. Well, he looked like a baby when he did that shit. This man really picked up a chair. Are you kidding? Like, he picked up, like, oh yeah, my biggest weapon yet, a fucking chair. Are you kidding me? He really picked up a chair? Yeah, then, yeah, you motherfucker, that's what you... Okay, he looked like he was fucking the wall. Yeah, he kind of did a little bit. Banging, lol. Whoa, miracle. This stream is not children appropriate. Oh, you can destroy the TV. They're go... Damn, I fucked myself up. I killed myself. Jesus. Oh shit, Nutty check DMs. I will in a bit. I'm trying to figure out how to burn the house down. Oh wait, maybe it's with the stove. Yeah, I think that's how you do it. Hold on a second. Oh my god! That reminds me of Carrie a little bit. When she killed her mom with those knives like that.
What are you doing, Aiden?
I'm trying to kill these guys. Yeah, that's how you catch the house on fire. You fuck with the stove, yeah. There we go. Yeah, burn, motherfucker. We can watch that replay and take some advice for some or two. Yeah, that's true. I think we should, the game teaches me how to kill people. Honestly, these pictures right here, I wonder if they're like developers and shit, like the kids of the developers, probably. Damn. Yeah, the house burned down. But it doesn't like burn down, it just like, I thought it would like burn to like fucking ash, but I guess not. Oh yeah. Who the fuck has a nail as a picture? Sometimes you gotta cut corners where you can, dude. I'm just gonna have this random picture of a nail. Oh, that, it's people like that make me want to kill them. I hate people like that.
Let's go home.
Elliot, you're not allowed to have friends anymore. You're not allowed to have friends anymore. 309. That's satisfying, though. Really, it is. The party. You and a percent of others have I'm going to actually look at these percentages, though. Oh, see, there's an undiscovered path. I wonder how you get that one. So it's possible not to get drunk. So it's mainly just that part with that guy. So it's possible to hide your powers. I wonder what happens when you don't show your powers. They probably just attack you, I guess. Like they do in the one part.
End of story.
Please.
Oh, fuck. This is what I was talking about. So she's like a gothic
rebellious teen, and she goes out, and she goes to this bar by herself, and she almost gets raped by these guys or something. It's stupid. Also saw a life hack about gluing a baby doll in the back of your phone case, so I went to the local adoption center and just showed the video and asked, can I make it happen? Long story short, right? Yeah, I'm not surprised you got banned.
I won't be late, I promise, okay?
You're wasting your breath, Jody.
It's just not fair! How come everyone can go and I can't?
Because you're... I do everything you ask of me. I like how she said, can I glue a baby to my phone? Sure.
For the 100th time, you're not like everyone else, and there are rules.
Well, I didn't ask to be...
He just goes, ah, ha, ha. He throws that pumpkin bomb at her. Oh, yeah.
I just want to go out and have friends and be like other girls my age.
You'll never be like...
Girls? You mean boys? What are you talking about, Elliot?
You need to get used to that.
No, this game came out way before the whole transgender thing. I don't even think he came out as gay at this point. What the fuck? She said, ah! What the God damn it. The stand is moving again. Gotta smack it with a hammer toe at this point. Oh my god, Jesus. Wow. This is crazy. What are these noises? She just keeps going, eh. Yeah, this. It's supposed to be like a, you know, oh, it's just a phase type thing. It's stupid. Like, and there's a part where you can play electric guitar. This part is just so cringy. I'm sorry. Like, it's just, like, I mean, I know it's part of the game, but it's like, what is this? Jesus. Yeah, because you can take, and then she walks around like she's all pissed off and shit. I know the perfect birthday present for her, a tree and a rope. Oh my god, dude. I mean, you're not entirely wrong. Maybe we should get her a noose. No, I'm joking. Is that a Super Nintendo? What the fuck? Oh, it's a VCR. Oh my god. Doesn't she scream? Yeah, she punches the fucking bed. What is she making out with the pillow? Jesus. Honestly, I think the gothic part is what makes this cringy. I mean, because it's such a cliche. It's like, oh, that gothic rebellious teen. You guys know that cliche. It's stupid. So you're not allowed to go into the bathroom. Okay. But yeah, pretty soon I'm probably going to have to be doing the FBI training or CIA, whatever it is. But yeah, you can play the air guitar, whatever it is, electric guitar. I don't know. My friend Aaron would be perfect for this, because I have no idea what the fuck this is. I don't play instruments. Oh, yeah, it's Guitar Hero 7, yeah! Air guitar. Oh, yeah, I'm stupid. I wasn't even paying attention. Yeah, she's playing air guitar when it's not even an air guitar. I meant to say electric guitar, my bad. Oh, shit. Look, see, guys, I have no brain. Yeah, get fucked. Oh, my God. Oh, you have to use Aiden to get her out. Yeah, I forgot. See, sometimes I keep neglecting Aiden in this game. I keep forgetting he exists. She's really banging on the door. Play the guitar and master it, you dumbass.
Oh, you hear me, Cole? Fucking let me out!
He's not gonna listen to you.
Hey, no swearing, okay, Jody?
Damn, no swearing. But see, the cool thing about Aiden is that he can possess people and kind of control them. So you basically control this guy, and you possess him, and then she gets out that way. That's how she gets out. It's kind of cool because he can control people.
This is not gonna do you any good.
But it's creepy though, because whenever he controls somebody, their eyes go into the back of their head, so it's like they don't have any pupils or anything like that. Oh Jesus! It's kind of like when a shark attacks. It's like it rolls its eyes in the back of its head. Well, damn! I destroyed that screen. That was $700, bruh. I'm very angry. How the hell do I fucking possess him? I know you have to possess him somehow. And then you get out. Bro, I just ate my mom's new burrito recipe. It's good. I actually wouldn't mind trying that because I love burritos. They're actually pretty good. God damn, you got me hungry now. Oh, wait, you have to destroy the camera. That's how you do it. I forgot.
Enough.
You just scissors throw it out the window, you dumbass.
You know where.
What are you calling a dumbass, dude? You're a dumbass. Fuck you. You're not even supposed to throw the fucking chairs anyway. Wait a minute, how the fuck do you do it? No, you. Is that pizza right there? Or is it talking about... Are you talking about, Jody? She... I don't even think she can do that. Like, so the gameplay in this game is very limited. Like, you can't... Like, it only lets you do shit that it, like, wants you to do, I guess. But how the fuck do you take possession of him? I think you have to do something here first. It's been a while since I played this.
I'm sorry, guys. Maybe I am a dumbass. Maybe I am an idiota. Wait, is this clothes? What the hell? Or coal?
It's Saturday night, and I'm locked up in here.
I already destroyed the camera. Now it doesn't make sense.
I can't do it, babe.
Did he really just say babe? Are you fucking kidding? What are you guys? I'm gonna say threaten.
You better let me out. You better let me out, because if you don't, I'm gonna stop working in class, and you can say goodbye to ever working with Aiden ever again.
Wow.
Knock it off, Jody. Now you're just acting like a child.
Now you're just acting like a child. She is, really. Can you imagine Elliot Page trying to threaten you, though? It's simply something I just wouldn't be able to take seriously. Oh, damn, she gave him the finger. But it doesn't make sense, because I already destroyed the camera, so it's like he can't even see it anyway. It's like she did that for no reason. Oh, my God. Oh, I'm sorry. You want to go to the party? She has a dyke haircut, too. Oh, my God. Jesus. Let me see if I can take control of him now. It should allow me to. Because there's a way you have to make him stand up somehow. How the fuck do you do it? Is there a knife? No, there's no knife, I don't think. Let me just keep messing with this. What am I doing wrong here? I don't... There's a way you have to make him stand up somehow. I don't know how, though. I mean, destroying that camera wouldn't make sense. Oh, shit.
Are you done?
Shit, slit wrist would've been... Oh, Jesus.
I hope so. Because you have to clean all that up.
Oh, wow. I don't have to clean this up, you do. This guy's just having a bad day. We're all having a bad day, how about that? Yeah, I don't know how to get his attention. I think you have to- Oh, wait. I think you have to do- Nope. I thought you had to destroy the TV. Oh, wait, he's picking up the phone, I think. Hold up. My damn sinuses. Oh, there we go, okay. I was wondering what I was doing wrong. Try to break the chair. Let's try to break his mind, because we're about to- Oh shit, that's not creepy at all. Can you imagine having that ability though? That would be so cool actually. Like, Jody Holmes from Beyond Two Souls could actually beat Thanos. Like, in a way, if you think about it. Like, all she'd have to do is get Aiden to possess him somehow. And then he could, he could just go into like a hypnotic state. Like that, and then she could just get the gauntlet off him.
You understand, right?
The only problem with that though, is that Thanos would probably use one of the stones to break it somehow. Because, you know, he has, like, the Mind Stone. Probably the Mind Stone would break that, probably. But that's, I don't know. Damn, Jody Holmes could actually... Where was she during Avengers Infinity War? What the fuck? Maybe all those people didn't get dusted. If she had showed up. If only you had showed up, and it's all your fault. Oh, you're supposed to walk. I thought there was, like, a cutscene or something. See, that's what I mean with this game. You never know when you're in gameplay or not. You just kind of have to guess. A113, I wonder if that's a Pixar Easter egg.
Yeah, I know.
Jesus. I like that necklace she has, though. It's kind of cool. I don't wear necklaces, though, because necklaces are gay. Wow. See, the thing is, wait, is this Department of Paranormal? Oh, yeah, I was about to say, is that the CIA logo or some shit? So now I think you have to get him to use his key card or something. Use it. Oh, I'm sorry. I have to do the prompt first. What if he just pulls out the card like that? He just goes over the thing. Oh, you have to take it from him. Now, see, the sad thing is that it's possible for him to die at the end. There's really... I don't mind spoiling games, because some people... Oh, I haven't got to play it, but this game is old as shit, though. 2013. Wait, come on now. Old. It's very old. Okay. But after this, I don't know, because this is in chronological order, I don't know what comes next. If this were the normal playthrough, like how it's played from, like, you know, just like the normal thing, it's not in order, but after this would be, I think that one part, I don't really like it that much, but this is in chronological order.
Well, hello, Cole. Jody.
Oh, this is awkward.
A bit late for day trip, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure. Tim, 1 week till Christmas Eve for me. Holy shit. That's crazy. Actually, it's funny you said that, because I think it just started snowing earlier, too. Which is crazy, because we haven't really gotten much snow this year.
Get some fresh air.
But...
Okay, you want I should call the infirmary?
No, there's no need. I'm,
That guy really looks like an M&M, I'm not gonna lie.
After me, so...
He really looks like an M&M. Yeah, and he's got those creepy-ass pupils. Or eyeballs, whatever.
What's up, Cole? Kid got your tongue?
Hmm? Wait a minute. July 1st, 2006? So this part of the game takes place in 2006? What? I didn't know it took place really that year. That's the same year Bully came out. Holy shit.
He isn't even...
2006. Yeah, but he's six. I'm joking. Alright, speak.
He lost his voice.
He lost his voice. That's the worst excuse ever. Are you kidding me? That is the worst excuse ever.
A virus or something.
I'm sorry, but if he was just blankly staring at the exit like that, I think there'd be a cause for concern right there.
I've gotten out of him all day long, so...
Yeah. It's not contagious, buddy.
This guy's the biggest fucking idiot ever. He really needs to be fired.
For all of us.
Hell, if I'd seen somebody's eyes looking like that,
right,
well, I'd think I'd be concerned. That guy's the biggest fucking idiot ever. Like, seriously, dude needs to lose his job. Dock his pay, whatever. Get rid of him. He's a nuisance. Because this guy doesn't know how to do his job. But I didn't even realize we've been streaming for an hour and 20 minutes. Hope y'all are enjoying the stream.
At least we don't have to look.
I'll probably do a few more levels and then I'll probably call it quits. But like I said, with this game, it should probably take no more than... 3 streams? Maybe 2. I'm looking at 2 streams, probably. But then again, though, knowing how bad I am at games, it'll probably be 3 streams. But once we do that, we're gonna do GTA 4 Chaos Mod, so that should be fun. This guy's definitely a rookie. Yeah, he really is. Like, how the fuck did you not see any of that? They had to take my butcher, so I had to leave for a few. Oh, you're fine. You're fine. I understand. Oh, wow. Imagine a ghost driving a car. He's a ghost rider, I guess you could say. What would you guys do if you ordered an Uber? And this fucker shows up and his eyes are like this, but he doesn't say nothing when you get in the car. He just takes off to his destination. Oh, my God. That would just be creepy. Oh, my God. No, you're fine. You're fine.
Damn. I mean, I'm not really out of sight.
Just start. Go. You mean call? My school had these tests to see how good you were at reading. I think my school had something like that too. I think.
Hey, call my man.
I know we had to do a lot of spelling tests too. And I was really good at those. I always got like a high score. Wow. Like if some guy's driving and he doesn't even acknowledge you like that, that's a cause for concern. Take off, go. Oh shit, it's GTA. Whoa! There is a part where you have to drive, though. Yeah, you had to do them at home. Except it was massive flaw. And then reset every year. I never understood teachers that send you home with a test. Because at that point, there's no point. You could just cheat. I mean, it'd be easy to look up the answers. Because I wouldn't trust that. Why would you send them home with a test?
You'll forgive me, right?
They're just gonna cheat on it. So in year 7, I got barely any tests. Oh, damn.
Don't worry, I'll be fine.
That is terrifying. Are you kidding me? Imagine seeing that in the woods. Like, imagine you're walking through the woods and you just flash your flashlight and he's just staring at you like that. Oh my god. That's creepy. They should make a horror game with that guy. There is a game called Five Nights at Shrek's Hotel. And it's gotta be the weirdest fucking game I've ever played. Ever since 8-11, I just roll out of my phone, high score. In my whole class, same questions each year. Year 8 through 11. Oh, yeah, that's cool. I mean, that's good that you excel in that. Because I was sort of like that when I was in grade school, like elementary. Had to do a lot of spelling tests. And I usually got pretty high scores on it. Never failed. But I do remember my teacher one year had us spell a giant word. Like, if you were the one to spell it right, you won some kind of prize. I think it was like candy or some shit. And I fucked it up so badly, I didn't get it. What am I supposed to be doing here? He just keeps walking back. Am I supposed to use Iden? Damn, CJ's gotten pretty fat over the years, and I'm joking. This reminds me when he's walking down that alleyway, too. Ah, shit. Here we go again. No, I'm joking. Except he's walking down the streets of Red County, apparently. Wait, oh, you're supposed to go this way. He just vanishes into the... Okay, nutty spell red. Red? What the f- Huh? Oh my god, it's the Ballad of Gay Tony. Those lights kind of remind me of Vice City a little bit.
The girls must be inside already.
Yeah, she is so dumb for this. Like, she gets sexually assaulted by these dudes. Can't miss you really bad. I don't miss you. No, I'm joking. I miss you too really bad too. I love you, baby. Her hair, like, her short hair kind of reminds me of that movie Hard Candy a little bit that she was in. Is that fucking, is that Lionel Dahmer? Jeffrey Dahmer's dad? Miracle, tell me that guy at that's bartending doesn't look like his dad. It kind of does a little bit. I'm sorry, but I would be so uncomfortable if that was me. Wait, like, imagine being a little girl like this. And you're like, there's a bunch of these big dudes in here. That would just be uncomfortable, especially if they're all staring at you.
How old are you, miss?
Oh my god, it's Lionel Dahmer. Yeah, Nutty gets like spell red. Spell red rum. Murder. Murder backwards is red rum. Jesus. Yeah, they just keep like looking at her. Like, what a fucking creep. Child molester. I'm just... Is this place really called Red House? Are you fucking kidding me? Wow. And some other kids are like, okay, spell... Yeah, that fucking word. Oh, I forgot how to say it. Oh, lemonade. Is that lemonade? And she doesn't even drink it. I never understood what people do. Like, they'll order a drink and then they won't drink it. It's like, what's the point then? What a waste. Same with food. Except I know a particular individual in this chat that does that with food a lot. I have to tell her constantly, eat your food, because she doesn't eat her food. Yep. This guy right here is a creep. Really, the dude tries to make a move on her. You really think of all people, she's gonna want to fucking come after you?
Wanna shoot some pool, darling?
No, you're a creep. He kind of, the way he's dressed, kind of, is, he kind of looks like Leo Casper from Manhunt 2 a little bit with that brown shirt and stuff.
Oh,
and
come on. We're just passing the time.
No, I don't want to. I always chose yes, but I think I'm gonna say no.
All right, just...
Oh, so she does it. What's the point of that, then? Is that just extra? Wait, what's the point? If I choose no, why does it do it anyway? That doesn't make any sense. Oh, God. I remember when this game came out, because it was originally a PS3 game, and then it was remastered for the PS4. And then it's playable on PS5, so... I bought this game for fucking $12.
Nice shot.
$12. It was usually like $30. I'm not spending $30. This game was actually on, is on PC as well.
Nothing.
Jesus. Oh, what's up, Dorian? How you doing, buddy? Love you more. No, you don't. No, just... Wow. This game is fucking lame, but I'm joking. Intra-pneumono... Ultra-microscopic silico-volcanoosis? I hope I didn't butcher that. Dude, get away from me, you fucking pervert. Damn, she told him how it was. She said, none of your business. But you mean to tell me, like... Why would she go to a bar like this by herself, though? Whoa. You're that doing good, getting some last-minute Christmas shopping done. Oh, hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. Yeah, because my mom was telling earlier how, there's gonna be 80 fucking presents under the tree, which 80% of which is gonna be for the baby. I can almost guarantee it. Because I've already wrapped, like, fucking 20 gifts that were for the baby. Which, and you know what's the funniest part? Is that I have to open them up. It's like, there's no point, because I already know what it is, because I already wrapped it. How to pronounce... Oh, that's how you pronounce it.
Come on, baby, you know you want to.
What is he? He sounded like Joel from The Last of Us. Oh my god. He said, come on, baby, you know you want to. Oh, hell no. Whoa. What is this? I don't like this. And play an Elden Ring. Oh, nice.
You mean that fucking shitty Dark Souls clone? No, I'm joking.
That's pretty cool, though. Show yourself. Oh my god. Yeah, you should have saw earlier. My fucking OBS keeps freezing my webcam, and I don't know why. I eat my damn food. I like how you just now acknowledge that. I mean, yeah, but sometimes it's like a fight to get you to eat, though. Ah, this shit again. Revenge once again. Oh, my God. And you got Jeffrey Dahmer's dad right there. Oh, my God. Yeah, that's what you get, you fucking perverted motherfucker. Rapist. Yeah, men like that actually disgust me. Like... I really hate rapists. It's just, it's fucked up.
You gotta get out of here, man. I don't like it.
Because, like, I'm not trying to go into detail or anything like that. But whenever I do stuff with Miracle, like, if she ever says, like, get off of me or I don't like that, then I would stop, you know, because if they just say no, just leave me alone. I mean, it's if they don't want to do it, they don't have to. Yeah, I beat two bosses yesterday. It took quite a few attempts. Oh, damn. So it's like Dark Souls, then. It's kind of hard. That's one of the reasons I don't play Dark Souls. It's because apparently it's a rage-inducing game. I don't know how rapists can sleep at night. Yeah, me either. Rapists, child molesters, and anybody really. Especially child molesters. Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Like, you really want to fuck a child? Like, come on now. That doesn't even make sense. Shit, Nutty ends rape. You're damn right, if I could, I would. Yeah, it's made by the same company as part of the Sorcerers. Oh, okay. Because I keep seeing everybody talking about how it should be Game of the Year and stuff. I don't have an opinion on it because I've actually never played it. Because I was never a Dark Souls fan anyway, so.
But I will play the new GTA. I'm joking.
Come to punish us for our sins.
Wow. This kind of looks like the bar in San Andreas a little bit. Especially in the countryside. Oh my god. Oh shit. Expect CJ to walk in.
We're getting the fuck out of here!
And you got Leo Casper right there. Actually, it looks just like Leo Casper. Like that guy that tried to rape her? He looks like Leo Casper if he was fat. Apparently Elden Ring is one of the easier soul games, more beginner-friendly. Wow, it's one of the more beginner-friendly games and it came out afterwards? That's crazy. Oh shit. Damn, destroyed the fucking LED lights. Wait, for a fucking $7 for shots? $4 for a beer? Are you kidding me? Fuck this place. I wouldn't go here ever again. These prices are enough for me to run away. Are you kidding me? I played For Honor and someone said, rep A, like, light spams WoW, replied with, suck a fart out of my arse. Oh my god. I like that. It's actually really nice. That's a very nice way to interact with other people that play. Whoa. So now I have to play as Jeffrey Dahmer's dad? Oh, he's got the shoddy. Oh shit. Ooh. Well, fucking Leo Casper's dad. Oh my god. That's rough right there. Yikes. But yeah, surprisingly it has been too bad for me, so I got the dodge and stuff down, so I don't usually unless it's but oh yeah, you don't usually die. And you see, it's funny because I've been playing Assassin's Creed Origins, which kind of follows a similar format to Dark Souls. And it's sort of like that, well, you have to it's more reliant on dodging. But eight balls. I'm doing a faith and intelligence build so I can use faith and magical spells. Oh, nice. Sounds like quite the game, actually.
It's okay.
That's the amount of balls that would have been in her if that spirit was alive and was part of the. Oh my god. She looks like she's smiling. Well, she's happy about it. She's like, I love this place. Definitely 10 out of 10 would go back if I could. Ah, shit. Like other girls. You and percent of other players. I'm gonna have to look at these. So it's possible to not get past the entrance guard? What? So it's possible to not kill any of the attackers. There's 20 different endings in this game, and it blows my mind. Like, there's a trophy to get all the endings. I don't think I could do that. Yeah, it's a massive world game, so it's a bit overwhelming. Not gonna lie, lots and lots of things to collect and do.
What's going on?
Oh, God. Just like Assassin's Creed Origins.
Get dressed.
I like that game. It's actually a pretty good game, and it was on sale, too. I got it for $12, and I really like it because it's not like a traditional Assassin's Creed game. Oh, I hate this one. Ah, I hate this level. But the 1% of people did attack the attackers. Yeah, they just were like, yeah, get her. No, I'm joking. What a bunch of fucking assholes. No, but, it's not like traditional Assassin's Creed games, because I'm going to be honest, the Assassin's Creed that came before Origins were actually too easy, because you just mash the buttons and you win. Yeah, I still need to play that game. I heard it was really good. Oh, yeah. Assassin's Creed Origins is awesome. But it's like one clip in a movie. Yeah, pretty much. Assassin's Creed Origins is RPG, so it's very different from your traditional Assassin's Creed. But because when I first played it, I actually hated it because I didn't like the combat. It was too difficult for me, but once I got the gist of it, it was actually pretty good, though. When it die, when it die. When it shrivel up and die. What the? Oh my god. Wedding ring. Oh my god. I just got proposed to. I think it's the Lorax. Oh, the Dr. Seuss. Yeah, the Lorax. I just watched the Grinch the other night, actually. And the max level in Elden Ring is 713, apparently, and I'm only level 5. That's the max level? Good god, 713? In Assassin's Creed Origins, the fucking... The max I think you can go is 40, I think? Jeez! 713, though? What are you thinking? That's fucking nuts, actually. She's the only one that can this. Assassin's Creed Origins is a great game, though. It's great. And it's the, it's the first Assassin's Creed, I'm pretty sure, that has a black protagonist. Well, he would be technically African, because, you know, Egypt is African. And you do up to New Game Plus... Plus 7 times. Okay. No, he has 2 weddings. Okay. And again? Yeah. Isn't that crazy? This man... I went from being some loser that sits in his room all day to being a loser that sits in his room all day that is a family man, I guess. Oh my god. Move. Elliot Page. You're doing too much. And this boy's so familiar. No, but, yeah, I hope they can say they can have more black characters. Yeah, because the only 2 black... Assassin's Creed characters I could think of off the top of my head would be Bayek from Origins and Adewale from Assassin's Creed 4. But there's a DLC where you can play as Adewale, though. But I was young and poor growing up, but after years of struggle, I'm no longer young. Oh my god. Yeah, I see, I like that. I like that. But god, it's the Green Goblin. Again, for the 30th time. Jesus. What was that thing I was laughing? Oh yeah, there was a thing I was laughing at earlier. Me and my friend were talking on the phone, me and my friend Aaron. And we were talking about Chucky, like Child's Play 2. And there's a part where he's in the back of the car and he has a fake water gun, but he's acting like it's a real gun. And he had me laughing because he said to the guy, he's like, "Now park this piece of shit," just the way he said. Oh my god, just the way he said. Oh my god, I love that movie. Chucky. It's just the way he said, "Now park this piece of shit." Yeah, my character in Elden Ring is Black Owl, and his name is Paradox. Nice. So that's cool, you can make your own character, actually. It's kind of like Skyrim a little bit. Which, Cameron Soup, he's not actually here at the moment. But I know he's pretty big into that game, Skyrim. He streams it a lot. But, yeah, Bayek would be black. Because I'm pretty sure he's black. Because the game takes place during ancient Egypt. And, you know, Egypt is actually... would be an African country, technically speaking. So he would technically be black, technically. I mean, because he's dark-skinned. But, yeah, although he doesn't speak. Oh, that sucks. I sincerely take back my action. Take back my actions by law. What the hell? I hate this part. This is one of my least favorite levels. It's just long and drawn out. I just don't like it. Oh my god, they got everything so accurate with her. Oh my god. Everything from the face to the way she walks and everything. Messages aren't sending. Oh yeah, YouTube probably filtered it out most likely. Oh, you have to use items. See, I keep neglecting him. Oh my god. Okay. Oh, this is trippy. I can't see shit. Damn it. Move down. What are you doing? Come on. You know you want to. I'm just... Oh, do you have to go through the elevator? Whoa. Are you really? Because I'm a dumbass. But yeah, Assassin's Creed Origins is good. I did play a bit of Odyssey, but its combat just felt weird. Like, it wasn't really like Origins. Like, it was just... I can't really do... I pressed the wrong button again. But, my favorite part about the new GTA is that you can play as a woman. Finally, but her name is actually Lucia, I think. There's two protagonists in, GTA 6. There's Jason and then there's Lucia. The game takes place in Vice City because the leaks pretty much confirmed it. And by the looks of it, it's gonna be a pretty detailed game. But now I'm forced by law to say I'm sorry for my comment. Oh yeah, you've been banned. I hereby sentence you to 24 months in jail. I'm joking. No, but Yeah, when you jump red lights, you crash the building. Makes sense. Yeah, that's based off the leaks that I've seen with GTA 6. It's shaping up to be a really good game from what I can see. Because look, I'm just gonna say this now. I beat a dead horse with this already. But the people that are literally bitching about it don't know shit about game development. Like, purely, oh, GTA 6, it looks like shit, it looks like GTA 5. Because it's not done. Do you not know anything about game development? Imagine you buy a frozen pizza from the store, you throw it in the oven for 2 minutes, and you take it out. It's not gonna taste very good because it's still frozen. That's how it is with GTA 6. The game isn't cooked all the way. It's, kinda not done yet. That's probably why it doesn't look very good graphically. When it comes out, it's probably gonna look amazing. But, naughty, naughty, naughty. What the fuck? Oh, no. Oh, I forgot about this crap, yeah. Oh, man. It's hey. Sorry about that.
I got sleepy.
Whoa, she said. I can't wait for Hogwarts Legacy and a new SpongeBob game. Oh, they're making a new SpongeBob game? Oh, shit. I did hear about the Hogwarts game. Oh, don't know who this loud guy is, but I timed him out for appropriate behavior. Oh, he's just a goof that is in my wife's rooms. Don't worry about him. Damn sinuses. But yeah, GTA 6 is, gonna be quite the game, I'll say that. But it takes place in Vice City, because in the one part, when Jason was walking through the metro station, you can see it said Vice City on the thing, so it's clearly in Vice City. Or is he just a troller? I don't know, dude. That was just a goof. It's a successor to the Battlefield. Oh, okay. Okay, that's pretty cool. I didn't even know they were making a new SpongeBob. That's kind of cool. I was hoping they'd make a sequel for this, but I'm joking. I don't think this game needs a sequel, but the thing I don't understand is that...
Go! Nothing! But death!
That's terrifying. But anyways, the thing I don't get about this game, though, is that the ending sets up itself as if there was going to be a sequel, but it never happened, though. Like, there's an ending where it literally seems like a sequel is just pretty much a necessity, but it never happened. And there's a few reasons why it never happened. Probably because the game didn't sell very well, probably. But the biggest reason is probably because of the whole transgender thing. Because, you know, Elliot Page, oh, I'm a boy now. They're like, oh shit, we can't do it. But then again, though, the sequel could have easily been made without Jody. Because it sets itself up like that the new protagonist would be that baby or something like that. But, I love how Nutty is lying in bed with Miracle when they try to have a decent conversation. He says, do you remember what CJ said to Ken? Who the fuck? Oh, yeah, in San Andreas, yeah. I remember that. That was actually really funny, too. Oh my god, that scared the fuck out of me. That guy's just like... Looks like Slenderman. Yeah, that's in...
Try to open it from
GTA.
The other side.
There's a part with Ken Rosenberg and CJ. There's a mission in Las Venturas. Where it's, I think it's called the meat business, it's inside of like a meat factory. And Ken Rosenberg says something like, oh, Tommy, I've missed these times so much. And then he's just like, who the fuck is Tommy? that's the guy you play as in Vice City. But what have I missed? Honestly, Liam, you haven't missed anything. Just us making fucked up jokes, and that's about it. But welcome aboard, Liam. Thank you for joining us. Oh shit. Wait, do you have to take... Wait a minute. Don't you have to possess his body or some shit? I don't know, it's been a while since I played this game, so... Oh, you have to hit that button. Got a screenshot of you shitting yourself? Oh my god. I do remember when I did Manhunt 2, though. And that, that guy said run all the way to San Andreas. I remember I got so ecstatic when I heard that. Oh my god! Also, in Manhunt 2, there's a guy that, he mentions Vice City, but I don't know how to find it, though. It's in one of the levels, but he mentions about taking a vacation there or some shit. I don't know if I would want to go to Vice City, especially if there's a guy in a blue Hawaiian shirt with a gun running around. Named Tommy Vercetti. I don't think I would want to go there. But yeah, CJ says that. He's like, who the fuck is Tommy? Oh, God. I love getting two-tapped by a boss. I was 3 hits from the kill. Aw, damn, yeah, I hate that shit. See, Dorian, you have far more patience than I do. Because that's the type of shit where I want to throw my controller at the wall. Because I remember I forget what game I was playing, but I got so close to defeating whatever, whomever, the boss, and I died. I was livid. I was going crazy. But I scared the shit out of me. He was just standing there. So, yeah, he really was. Sorry I added to your comment, by the way. Might have to go take a... My sinuses took a shit. Might have to do some. You have broken a video game disc playing a game. Yeah. That's true. With Vice City, I broke the disc. Because the game was fucking bullshit. I mean, it's like, what did it want me to do? I tried to kill Lance. And then I tried to defend my safe. And then it's like, oh, you died. I'm like, fuck you, dude. Whatever. Whatever, cockstar. I don't know what you want me to do. It's annoying as hell. My endurance bar is empty, so I can't roll and get... So I couldn't roll and got caught. Ah, dude, that is... That's tough right there. That's some bullshit. My biggest problem with Assassin's Creed Origins, though, is that there's times where when you get into combat, it's borderline unfair in a way, because there's these guys on horseback with bow and arrows, and I swear to God, they're the most annoying fucking hostile NPCs in that game. Because I'll admit, Assassin's Creed had its moments, like Assassin's Creed Unity especially drove me crazy, but Assassin's Creed Origins, though, like, there's moments where I want to chuck my controller at the wall, because it's like, what the fuck? I died because the guy was on fucking horseback. What do you want me to do? It's fucking dumb. Nutty, can I ask you one thing? As long as it's nothing too personal, sure. Because I know you make a lot of references to... I'm just going to be blunt. My sex life, but I'm not going to get into that, because that's nobody's business. But at the end of the stream, if we have time, can we watch... Is this Chris Graham? No, yeah, sure. Sure. And also, now I watched that anti-piracy screen, so you don't have to ask me about it anymore. Yeah, I was close to this boss, and I'm more of a range fighter since I use spells, so the boss closed at the distance it got to me. Ah, damn, that sucks. Well, I wish you good luck on it. I hope you beat it, because that's been... It is a tad bit creepy. Yeah, but it was more hip, you know? It sounded good, and I liked how Dr. Robotnik, of all people, was telling me piracy was bad. But the Sonic CD one can go fuck itself, though. That is creepy. That's creepy. Alright, guys, I gotta blow my nose. I'll be right back. Just hold on. Sorry about that. I may as well just have a towel on deck, because I fucking might myself. Oh, God, I'm orange. And I also look like a ghost. My God. Oh my God. Holy shit. My webcam, I looked like a ghost. Now I look too dark. Hold on 1 second, Dory, and I'll read it. It's kind of... Sorry, that should be good. But if you get scared, you must be one. F1 race start time. Is it going to be a race car? No. I like how we just put no in lowercase letters. But I think I may do a summon and have some wolves distract the boss so I can cast without having to constantly roll around. Yeah, that sounds pretty strategic. I like that idea. But let me tell you though, Assassin's Creed Origins, I mean, that's like the closest thing I can compare that to, because I don't really play Dark Souls. But Assassin's Creed Origins, the combat, when I was playing on the PS5, because they patched it on the PS5 to run at 60 FPS, and not only is that game absolutely beautiful, but the best part about it is I remember I was playing it, and I was having so much fun with the stealth and the combat. And I literally said to myself, I haven't had fun with a game like this in years. Like, it was really fun. Like, the stealth and combat in the game is really fun. But also the words you couldn't read. Read Dr. Robotnik's Pirates games. Don't be like Robotnik. Oh, okay. So it says don't be like him. All right. That's actually... Because I was going to say, like, Robotnik of all people is the one telling me not to pirate shit. Wouldn't he be the one that's saying, yes, please pirate. Definitely do it. Oh my goodness. Okay, can I go through the window I broke? Why didn't she just do that in the first place? No, it says don't be like him. Yeah, that's what I meant. I mean, I couldn't read it. Because at first I thought it was Robotnik telling me that. But but until you told me what that text, because it got cut off, I couldn't really see it that well. But I love stealth in RPG games. Early on in Elden Ring, I was using stealth to kill it. Yeah, it's really satisfying too. Because I would laugh, because I would kill one of the guys, and then the other guy would be like, hey, wait a minute, and then I would pull out a bow and arrow and shoot him in the head with it. Oh my God. The combat in the game is really, really fun to do. There's just moments where you can get overwhelmed rather easily. especially when there's a ton of enemies, especially on horseback with bow and arrows. But it's ancient Egypt, which is a nice setting. And you can visit the pyramids and shit. But the thing is the only thing that kind of disappointed me with it is that it doesn't take place in, like, ancient Egypt. It's sort of, like, near the end of that era, I guess. Like, it's, like, whenever you play that, it's like the pyramids had already been built for, like, thousands of years. My favorite thing to do in Minecraft is get 100 skeletons in one room and stand in the middle. Then go and create it. Oh, yeah, that's a death wish right there. Oh, it's a shooting. That's actually a cool idea. I never thought about doing that. Yeah, I usually get overwhelmed when I face four more, especially melee. Yeah, definitely. Because there's a type of enemy in that game called brutes. And there's these really big guys, and they have these really big hammers and shit. And if they get a hold of you, it's like... It's almost a death wish. But that is a game we're definitely going to do a playthrough of. The Piranesi Order is very clunky, in my opinion. Really? And that's how I felt about Odyssey. I didn't really like the parry in that game. Like, it felt like I was doing it, but he wasn't, like, dodging it. I'm like, what the fuck is with the combat, though? But then they shoot more skeleton. The winner, death by lava. Oh, Jesus. Like, yeah, you won. Here, you get to die in lava. Fuck you. But and then I played Valhalla for a little bit. Didn't like it that much. It didn't even feel like an Assassin's Creed game to me. I don't know. Those big kind of enemies are scary. Yeah. It's very scary, actually. Play Brawlhalla. I stream Brawlhalla. I'm not good enough at it to actually stream it. Like, because it's a fighting game. I'm not really good at fighting games. I don't know. But Assassin's Creed Origins is definitely a game that's on the list of playthroughs we're going to do. I think once we do GTA 4 Chaos Mod, I think that's when we'll do Assassin's Creed Origins after that. Because that is a game I really want to actually beat on stream. Because that's a good game. Like, At first I fucking hated that game, but once I got the gist of the combat, I was like, this game is fucking amazing. And it's absolutely beautiful, too. Like, that game came out in 2017, and it's absolutely stunning. Like, it looks really good. Really good still. Earlier, a great white dragon started to aggro on me, and I ran for my freaking life. Yeah, I'd imagine, if it was a dragon, especially. Oh my goodness. God damn it. Poor Miracle, she don't even play video games. She has no idea what we're talking about. I don't even know what I'm supposed to be doing here. I just don't get it. What's the point of turning these soda machines on? I don't really get it. Because you're supposed to put out the flames somehow. Oh, wait, no, there's a guy over here. Let me try to walk over there. What's that? I'd say Valhalla and Odyssey parry are better than Origins because the buttons to parry were next to each other. Yeah, I see what you mean. Like, it's more convenient that way. But personally, with Assassin's Creed Odyssey, I didn't even get past the tutorial because the combat was just... It felt weird to me. Like, I would dodge and you wouldn't do nothing. I'm like, what the fuck does the game want me to do? But one game you could play, Roblox. Some more games that... I've streamed Roblox before, but I mean, if you want me to, we could do that. I have a few people that actually want me to do Roblox, so... I can see it happening. I can't really fight it until I'm more closer to level... Like, level 80 to 100, unless I have other players I'll be fighting. Oh, so it's a multiplayer, okay. That's kind of cool. Hold on 1 second, guys. There, now, you happy F1 racer right there? Bro, what haven't you streamed? Honestly, there's a lot of games I haven't streamed, but I've streamed a lot. I don't think I've ever streamed GTA, though. I might do one of the GTA games. No, I'm joking. As if I haven't streamed every fucking GTA game known to man. Especially San Andreas, that poor game. I've streamed that game so many times. And you know what's funny is that I have plans to do another playthrough of that next year, like the PS2 version. Oh my god. Next year. Probably the second half of next year. He hasn't streamed Pornhub, but never will. Yeah, because if I do that, then that's the end of my streaming career. Or not career, but just gig, I guess. Like I said, I enjoy doing this, even if I don't make any kind of money from it. It's a lot of fun to do. It's a lot of fun. Ah, damn. GTA SA, you can stream in your sleep. Yeah, probably. I mean, same with Manhunt. That's another game I've streamed to death. Like, I've streamed that game so many times, I probably could beat that game while I'm sleeping. Because I've played Manhunt, like, over a million fucking times. Oh my god. Somebody should do it if they have the time. Make an edit of this, and they should just insert the CJ screams when he catches on fire. Oh my god. Jesus Christ. The fucking screams. Good lord. Manhunt is a game I can beat in my sleep. I beat an invader yesterday. He was a melee fighter and upranged, so I stay on top of this Rupert's man with spells till he died. Oh my god. Dude didn't even give him a chance. He said nope. I'm just gonna get rid of you now. Oh my goodness. Yeah, that sounds like a cool game. I've heard good things about it. Elden Ring, but I've never played it though. All I know is that it's just like Dark Souls, which I have played Dark Souls before.
No, please,
I think I played Dark Souls 2, and I never got past the tutorial because it wasn't the fact that it frustrated me. It was more so I just couldn't get into it. That was it, really.
I know they're still here.
Try to get to the elevator.
Is he the only sane person here? Everybody else is waking up either dead or alive. I don't know, this game is trippy.
Those things will kill you.
Okay.
I'm not alone.
We always fix
Jesus. He was trying to steal my runes, which are used to over. Oh, okay. God, those are... Of course, the only guy that's alive gets killed. Oh my god. Did he really just say, die, you little bitch? Oh, that's creepy when they do that with their head. Wait, since when did they have directional arrows? I guess since it's in chronological order. Just hold on 1 second. Niall, I'm trying to do this real quick. Come on, Elliot, use your transgender skills. No, I'm joking. prove to him that you're a powerful transgender. Oh my god. Oh, nice. I did it slightly wrong. And I paid the price. But in one game I played a lot, Space Invaders. What's in a giant arcade? Space Invaders machine got the high score of the name. Ass. Oh my god. I feel like everybody does it. Like they put butt or something like that. I had like 10,000 on me, you know, and I was like, oh hell no, you can't have these. It's like, nah, you're not allowed. I've worked so hard for this. Don't take it away. Use the power of Q. Oh jeez. But see, it didn't affect them at all. What's with that head movement? Like they go like, wait, what the fuck is with that? That's just freaky. Come on, Elliot, use the power of love. I am woman. Oh my god. No, Elliot is a boy. You have to respect that. It's like Elliot Page comes in the chat and is just like, what? No, I'm joking. It's like, I came to watch my game be streamed. You're over here fucking calling me a woman? Oh no, we ain't having that. Shit. God, it's like the end of a horror movie or something. Moments before disaster. Use power trans lover. Yeah, pretty much. Oh my god. You know what's funny? I hate to say this, and I'm not even exaggerating it either. There is a character in this fucking game, and I kid you not, he looks exactly like Dorian. I'm not even trying to be funny when I say that. Like, I think I have a screenshot of it somewhere, and I can even show you guys. I am being so serious right now. Like, he literally looks exactly like Dorian. Oh yeah, speaking of which, I played that Stray game too, where he plays the cat. That was actually, I actually liked that game. It was pretty cool. Oh jeez, guys, look at that shit. CJ. Oh my god, I have it somewhere. It's one of my older screenshots. I gotta go way back for it real quick. But I swear to god, it looks just like him though. But I'll lose top of cranium. Yeah, he lost the top of his fucking head. Oh my god, it's Jimmy Hopkins. Oh my god, it's Big Ben. Where the hell is that screenshot at? I know I have it somewhere. I like how I just have a screenshot of Arthur Morgan's face. There's a status effect that be put on the player that if the meter fills up, it causes instant death. What the fuck? Yeah, see, fuck that shit. Yeah, there it is right there. Dorian, that... If you had a little bit more facial hair, that would look exactly like you. I'm not even trying to be funny. I'm not trying to make fun of him or anything. But he's playing Jet... Yeah, I actually have Jetpack Joyride on my PS5. I think I paid like $2 for it. Oh my god. And you know what's funny? There's a character in this game that looks like me too. Ain't that some shit? Wow. I'm sorry I have to keep clearing my sinuses, guys. I've always had that issue my entire life. I've always had sinus problems. I don't know why. Ever since I was a kid, even I had sinus issues. Bro, not them using my face without my permission. Yeah, it's just like, nah, I didn't give you permission. Lawsuit time. Honestly, you probably could. You could make up a bullshit lie and say they used your face without your permission. Which is the irony of that statement is pretty crazy, because It reminds me of that whole Last of Us fiasco that happened back before The Last of Us came out. Back when The Last of Us came out, Ellie's face kind of looked a little bit different. And in pre-release trailers and stuff and screenshots, her face, it looked kind of the same, but it didn't look exactly how it looks. And it looked more like Ellen Page. And there was this big thing about it, like, there was like this whole lawsuit thing, like, oh, they used my likeness without asking and shit, it was stupid. They secretly used both your and Dorian's face, yeah, they really did. Because there's a character in this game that not only does he sound like me, he looks like me, and he also has my nose. Isn't that fucking crazy? It's like they must have used both of us without us knowing. But I just want my cut of the money made, yeah, pretty much. He's like, where's my money at? If you want to know the name of the company, their name is, what the fuck? I think, who made this game? It's right on the tip of my tongue. Who made this? What is the name? It's like Dream something. Who made this fucking game? It's the same people that made Heavy Rain. What the fuck? Dreamscape or fucking Dream something? Dreams? I don't remember. Quantic Dream, yeah, that's what it is. Oh my god, I said Dreamscape, oh my god. That sounds like some generic PC game or something. Wow. Yeah, Quantic Dream, yeah, thank you. So yeah, if you want to get a hold of Quantic Dream, then there you go. Damn. Some crazy shit. So who said it first? Niall, you said it first. At least that's what my chat says. Oh, who damaged the screen? Who damaged my 4K monitor? Are you kidding me? There's a game called RuneScape. Yeah, I've heard of that game. Oh my god. Jesus. Oh shit. Let's go. I mean, I wasn't aware it was a contest. Jesus. You see, I was wrong. I thought Manhunt 2 actually didn't have any type of soundtrack to it, but it actually does. And there's a soundtrack called the Dungeon. And I love that sound. It's just like looped music. But it sounds really good, actually. Yeah, press R1. Oh my god, autoerotic excruci... Oh yeah. Jesus Christ. Fixation? Oh, Jesus Christ. That's my face whenever somebody tells me something crazy. I'm like... like that guy was. Oh yeah. No, but come on, sinuses, you're driving me crazy. I am going crazy. Oh my god. No, but maybe we can slip through. Yeah, it's called The Dungeon, though, and I really like how the music sounds in that part. That game is you know, the irony is that, oh no, I'm thinking of Vice City Stories. Never mind. I was gonna say, that's chronologically, that'd be the last game in the 3D universe, which is kind of cool. Okay, we're not getting into this. Oh my god. By the time you play that, CJ killed Big Smoke 15 years ago. Okay, we're done. Okay, we get it. CJ did all that shit in San Andreas 15 years ago when you played Manhunt 2. We're not going to talk about that. Nobody cares. The only person that cares is you, Robbie. Nobody else. Alright. Oh, this part I think is a puzzle. I forget what to do here. Oh, shit. If you guys think of it, everyone has a voice in their head. Yeah. Everybody has that voice, you know? I have many voices in my head. I'm joking. That just sounds really fucked up. Oh my god. Yeah, dude, I have multiple voices in my head. Jesus. Hey, Miracle, I don't know if you're still here. Hey, Nutty, remember that band mission on GTA? Hot Coffee. The Hot Coffee incident. Yeah, I remember that. That was actually an entire mini game. It wasn't even just a mission. And it was a big controversy because originally Rockstar envisioned CJ being able to have sex in that game. They really wanted to push that feature. And it was removed because it would have gotten an adult-only rating. And some hacker, I think he was from, like, Poland or some shit, he went into the game's code, and he restored it. And then when they figured it out, Rockstar got him deep shit for it. So much so that the game was temporarily adult-only. It's called the Hot Coffee Incident. Which is funny, because in later GTA games, they talk about it. It's just pixel why they upset. Honestly, I don't even know. I mean, I think it's stupid. It's like, you can shoot people in broad daylight, you can kill the police in that game, but God forbid you do something that's natural. It doesn't make any sense. I never understood. It's like with Manhunt. When that game first came out, it saw a lot of controversy. but it wasn't, but it's really not as violent as people say it is, though. Check your DMs, we can reenact this. No, not doing it. We're not doing hot coffee reenact, but, oh my goodness. The camera in this part really annoys the shit out of me. Because the way it's placed, it's placed way too close to her body. I can't. They tried really hard to make it cinematic. Like, you see the screen kind of moves like a movie a little bit. I don't like that. Kind of ruins it. I mean, it's a video game at the end of the day. It's not a movie. I don't understand why they bothered. They should have just made this into a movie. Why'd they make it into a game? I don't really get it. But just make it into a fucking movie. Wow, those must be important notes there. That guy's having the time of his life. She's gonna fucking die of hypothermia if you don't fucking... if I don't hurry up. Oh, wait, no. Do you need to break the glass? I think you need to break the glass somehow. Hot coffee is in GTA 5. Well, they make subtle references to hot coffee. Like they'll be like, oh, can I come in for some coffee? Because it was a big controversy. Like, it was all these politicians got involved with it. And they're like, oh my god, you can have sex in this game. This game is bad, even though you can shoot people in broad daylight. In the game. It doesn't, like, I don't understand that. It's so back-assed, it doesn't make any sense. It doesn't really make any sense. Hot coffee reenactment with pixel costumes, oh my god. Just print a picture of CJ's face out on him. Like a cardboard mask or something. It's funny because the animations still exist in the game's code, and you can restore it and everything. Like, you can actually, like, it's kind of fucked up, actually. Still here and pissed off. Oh, jeez. Don't be angry at me, I'm sorry. I don't know what I'm supposed to do here. I better not have to look up a guide. I don't want to do that. There's gotta be a way you can break the window. There has to be. That's the only way she's gonna be able to get in. Unless you're supposed to get the key card off one of these guys. Oh my goodness. This is driving me crazy, guys. I think I might go nuts. I think they might have to admit me into the psych ward. I'm going nuts right now. Oh, jeez.
It's like beyond two souls made me this way.
Oh my god. Reminds me of McChugger Nuggets. Like, I really thought that shit was real for years. But then when they started making shit like, oh, psycho kid kills dad, I'm like, yeah, see, this shit's fake. There's no way he killed his dad. That's not a good sign, Mira. No. Honest to God, when she's pissed off, she actually kind of scares me a little bit. Kind of scares me. Can I just pick up the corpse and throw it through the window? Will that break it? I seriously don't even know what to do. I haven't played this part in fucking, not years, but a long time to say the least. I don't know what to do. But a cool thing you can find in Assassin's Creed Origins is when you go into the modern day sections, you can actually find Bayek's mummy. Like you can find his mummy. And it's kind of cool, actually, because you can actually see his thing. But the thing that bugs me is that they don't explain how and when he died. But, I mean, obviously he'd be dead, obviously, modern day, because, you know, that's ancient Egypt. But you can find his mummy. But the cooler thing, too, is that on his sarcophagus, or whatever that fucking thing is, the mummy thing, the container, I guess, you can find a picture, like his face on it, like painted on a piece of wood. And it's kind of neat because I looked into it, and it was actually a real tradition back then. And it's called, I think, just mummy portraits, I think. And the subscribe button, eager for a click. Oh yeah, my description thing. Psycho Kid kills his dad, he doesn't have the balls to kill him. It was so forced. Like, by that point, I'm like, yeah, that shit's fake. But pretty much, the reason they have a picture of Bayek on his coffin, I guess, where his mummy is because they used to have a tradition back then in ancient Egypt. And they're basically just called mummy portraits. And what they would do is when the person would die and they wrapped them up into a mummy and shit, they would paint a picture of them. And then they would kind of put it onto the coffin, I guess. It was a tradition they used to do. And it was, I don't know if it was when they died, but I think what they do it as is that they painted them when they looked at their best, I guess. When they looked at, like, how they looked at their best. And, in Bayek's case, on his picture, I'm like, he must have died young, because he looks exactly how he looks in the game. But that's not the case. I mean, he could have died of old age. They probably just painted it whenever he looked his best, I guess. But, are you mad at me? I'm not mad at you. No, she's not mad at you. Like you see in modern day, kind of in a way how they have a picture next to the casket. It's sort of like that. But what they would do is that they would actually, like, they would take a piece of wood and then they would paint on it. And then they would kind of put it on top of the casket, sort of, I guess. It was kind of to show what they looked like, I guess. I don't know. But it's weird because the one in Origins, it looks pretty cool. But in real life, they just look creepy, though, like the real life ones. Because their eyes are really big and shit, I don't know, just, it looks really creepy. And I'm gonna say this now, I have a thing that's really weird. I don't even know what to do here. But, there's a thing with me where I dead bodies just make me sick for some reason. I don't know why. Like, I lose my appetite if I see a coffin or something, like, especially when it's open. And, whenever I was looking at those mummy portraits for, like, days, I couldn't eat because I realized all these people were dead. I mean, like, I'm looking at dead people. I don't know. I was a bit of a weird kid growing up. Me too, actually. But I just have this weird thing where just corpses make me ill. I don't know why, it's weird. And so for days, because I was looking at all these different, you know, people, like these mummy portraits. And when I was looking at them, I mean, it was like they looked okay. Like they looked normal because their eyes were open and shit. But they, the fact that I knew that they were dead people is what made me sick. I knew the entire lore of Friday the 13th. I mean, honestly, I was playing Manhunt when I was like 10 years old, so you're not entirely weird. You're not weird. I really don't even know what to do here. I'm so are you kidding me? I stood there and flew around for hours. No, not hours, but minutes. And you have to find some kind of key code, I think. I feel so stupid right now. I'm the biggest idiot in the fucking world. The inscriptions are high off of the ancient green stuff. Oh, yeah. Yeah, they really are, to be honest. Oh, my God. I thought I just heard Jody say, fuck me, whenever she was walking through the thing. She probably did. Especially since she's freezing. But, yeah, I mean, it's kind of fascinating how they did that with the mummies. But I just have this aversion to dead bodies. Like, they just make me sick for some reason. I don't know why. It's weird. And so I'm like, yeah, these people look very alive in the picture, but they're dead. That's the thing. But the fucked up part about those portraits is that they were exclusive to higher class people, which that was normal back then. So if you were lower class, fuck you. Oh my God. What the hell is that, a zombie? Look, she's being attacked by zombies. Or like just lifeless people, I don't know. What are they growling at me? Are they zombies? Oh, that's terrifying. Oh my God. Jesus. Damn, Elliot, you're on a roll today. Look at you.
Come on.
She said, come on.
I need you now.
No, you don't need me. Hold up. I'm still talking, guys. Just hold on. What's with that head jerk? Oh my God, it's like GTA 4 whenever they ragdoll. Oh my God. Like when they just fall over like that. Jesus Christ. I'm half expecting Nico Bellic to fall over. Jesus. There you go. Endless waves of the undead. They didn't even try to go through the door. It's like they just fucking... Like, they actually shut it. It's like they wandered around. It's like, yeah, we just want you to get out of here. Is all. But yeah, ancient Egypt is a very interesting time period. But yeah, like... Because when I looked at the portrait of Bayek from Origins, when I seen his mummy portrait, I mean, I looked at it and he looked exactly how he looks in the game. I was confused. Well, he must have died young. But then when I did research, they painted these people when they looked their best, I guess. At their best. So, I mean, he could have died of old age. They just painted him what he looked like whenever he was, like, young, I guess. I don't know. I mean, same with his wife, Aya, too. I think her name was Aya. And, you can find her mummy, too. You can find her mummy portrait, too. But, zombies be like, please leave. Yeah, pretty much. But you can find her, her mummy portrait as well. Oh, my goodness. Oh, I remember this part. Oh. See, I really don't like this part. It's a major pain in the ass. Because you have to shut down this generator thing. It's very obnoxious. Because it takes very long. And me doesn't like long shit. That guy's in the weirdest pose. What the fuck is he doing? He has his leg all propped up on the desk. Honest to God, he looks at... Never mind, I'm not gonna say it.
This stream is not children appropriate. No.
My God. How do I get through? If you have epilepsy, look away. I'm not even trying to be funny when I say that, seriously. If you guys have, like, a sensitivity like flashing lights, I wouldn't look at it. Stuff like that can actually trigger seizures. I'm not even joking. I mean, that's obviously a no-brainer, but still. I'm just making a disclaimer right now. Alright, how do you... Obviously, you have to get through that door. That's what I hate. This level just drags on and on and on. But the goal, though, is that we want to try to beat this in two streams, but if that doesn't happen, then I guess it'll be three. And then we'll do GTA 4 Chaos Mod. I don't know if we'll do a playthrough of it. I think we'll just do one stream on it, and I think we'll be done, because I did already do a playthrough of GTA 4. So I don't even see a reason to play through the game again. Oh shit. I don't know what I'm supposed to do. The game is just like, don't know what to do, can't help you. Are you fucking... Just go through the door. You probably have to fuck with the computer to open it. Oh Jesus. I remember in the McJugger Nuggets video. Oh yeah. See guys, I don't have a brain. I really don't. If I only had a brain. Oh, it doesn't work. Great.
She said a bad word. She said, oh shit.
Oh my goodness. Miracle's like, I'm mad at you, but I'm not mad at you. I'm joking. What the hell is that? Is that a jellyfish? Yeah, you gotta get over there to shut it down or something. I like how they snuck the theme song in. The theme song in this game is actually not too bad. Actually kind of good. Like, this game has actually semi-decent soundtrack. But I said, in order to get into a game like this, it really has to... Like, you have to be into a specific category of games to enjoy this. I'm not saying the game is bad. I'm just saying it really caters to a very niche audience, I guess. It's not something you see very common, is what I'm trying to say. Somebody like that enjoys Telltale would like something like this, I would say. It's sort of like a Telltale game, but not really. That's all I can really say. Sort of not, sort of is. Oh shit. Wait, how the fuck? I hate this thing. This thing is really wonky. I hate it. Just do it. Jody! Yeah, there you go.
The energy level in the...
Yeah, she can see into the past. Oh, shit.
We've got to shut it down! Now!
Oh, my God. Yeah, quick time event lovers and movie watchers. Yeah, pretty much. Because this game has a lot of quick time events. Like, a lot of them. So, yeah, I see what you mean. Like, quick time events. Which, I don't mind quick time events. I know a lot of people hate those, but they don't really bug me that much. I mean, I think, honestly, it changes the pace of the gameplay, but I don't really see what the big deal is about it. Everybody's like, oh, I hate those. All you're doing is pushing a button. I don't get it. Like, for instance, I mean, this has nothing to do with anything, but I'm the type of guy where when I play certain games, after a while, I kind of want it to just be over. And I remember when I was watching DSP play GTA Vice City Stories, somebody in the comments they were complaining about how Phil was bitching how there's one less mission or something like that. And he's like, if that was me, I'd be wanting more missions. But I'm sorry, but if I'm playing a game and it's just dragging on and on and on and on, it's like after a while, you kind of just want it to be over with, you know? You don't want to be sitting there playing the same game over, like, for hours and hours. I mean, after a while, it's like, can this just be over? In Sonic Unleashed, there are quick time events where you press square 50 times? Jeez. 50 times. That's quite the quick time event. I never beat that game either. I tried to. I kind of want to go back and beat it. Because I still have it for the PS3, but I never beat it. It was those Werehog levels that were too difficult for me. But I'll never forget that combat music, though, whenever you get when you play the Werehog. That oh my god, I love that song. That is a certified classic right there. The final part. Oh yeah, that giant purple thing, I forget what it's called. It comes out of the earth or something like that. I remember that game. I used to play the fuck out of Sonic Unleashed. It was those damn Werehog levels, though. I couldn't do it. It was too difficult. I think I might actually play it, though, tonight. Maybe for a little bit. Dark Gaia, yeah, that's what it's called.
I run.
But I'll never forget that combat music, though. Okay. Oh my god. The only thing I remember is that when you take damage as the Werehog, he's like, ah, or something like that. Because, you know, his voice is a little bit deeper, I think. Like, it sounds something like, I'm Sonic! Sonic the Hedgehog! Oh, shit. Yeah, remember that time that Sonic was a fucking werewolf? Yeah. Me neither. No, I'm joking. Oh, my God. No, but Sonic Unleashed is a pretty... I would say, like, the black sheep of the Sonic series, at least, like, modern Sonic, that is. Because I feel like it's like a love-hate relationship with that game, with a lot of people. Like, you got, like, it's divided, I guess. Well, you got people that hate it, you got people that love it. In my case, I can't really form an opinion on it. Because, A, I haven't played the game in years, and B, I if I'm being honest, I actually like classic Sonic more than modern Sonic. Because a lot of the modern Sonic games just feel the same, in my opinion. Although, I did hear that Sonic Frontiers is actually pretty good. So, I'm thinking of giving that game a try, because a lot of people were shitting on it before it came out. But from what I heard, it's actually a pretty solid game. I think the main vocal theme of Sonic Unleashed and Most Possibilities may be my best song of all time. I don't remember that one. The only songs I remember is the Werehog combat music and the song that plays when you get your results at the end of a level. At least the modern day ones, I think. Or not modern day, but daytime levels. And the only thing I remember about that song, it went something like, it was like, that's like the only thing I remember that about that song. Damn, I kind of want to play that game now. Like, I actually kind of want to stream it. Actually, as a matter of fact, I think that'll be the next playthrough. After we do GTA 4 Chaos, I think I'm going to do Sonic Unleashed, because that is a game I want to beat, actually. Because I never got the chance to beat that fucking game. The only modern Sonic game I ever beat was Sonic Generations, and that was it. Those were, like, that's the only Sonic modern Sonic game I played. I killed it. I'm just, I killed it, homie. Because I do kind of want to do more platformers on this channel. I kind of want to do more stuff other than GTA. I'm trying to, you know, branch out a little bit more. The only reason I'm doing Chaos Mod, though, for GTA 4 is because I never did something like that, and I've heard Chaos Mod is actually fun. The results are the same for 9 Day, if you get... Oh, okay. Okay. Yeah, and if you don't get anything other than the E, it's offset. Yeah, it's like it plays like a shittier version. Yeah, I remember that. It's like... Like the trumpets and shit are all fucked up. Yeah, I remember that. God, that game, I still have it for the PS3. I really want to play it now. Because that game is... It was hard. I could never beat it. It was those Werehog stages. They were too difficult. Because I'd always get my ass kicked. And those fucking... Those black things that attack you. They kind of look like the... What are they called? I think the Forgotten or some shit on Kingdom Hearts. Like those black things that you have to fight. Oh, jeez. Yeah, Kingdom Hearts is a game we'll probably never do. Simply because it's an RPG. And I don't really like RPG games. I mean, Assassin's Creed Origins is RPG, but... I just love the combat in the game. That's why I like it so much. It's really satisfying for me for some reason. I don't know. That's how I feel. But Sonic Unleashed is definitely something that's on the agenda, though. Because, come to think of it, I haven't played that game in so long. Like, I actually really want to play it now. But a Heartless... Oh, yeah, the Heartless. That's what they're called. The Heartless. Yeah, I don't know why I thought they were called the Forgotten. Because I actually played Kingdom Hearts not too long ago on the PS5. And it's just a game that's just not for me. I mean, I like it because the Disney characters are in it and shit. But it's... I don't know. I think the furthest I got in that game, I think, was the... where you meet Goofy and Donald, I think. And that's it. Apart from that, I didn't get too far in that game because I got stuck. I didn't know what to do. I was just running around aimlessly. I'm like, I don't know what the fuck to do. I quit. So I just gave up. I'm just... Well, geez, this is a lot, ain't it? Holy shit. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. But yeah, that... I still have it. I don't have the case, but I have the disc. Because when I was a kid, my dad used to do this thing with my games. I don't know why he would do it. But he would take the disc out of the case, and then he would throw the cases away. I don't know why he would do that. And back then, I didn't really give a shit. Because I didn't know how to take care of games back then. And I would leave discs sitting out, and it would have thumbprints and scratches all over them. But nowadays, I know how to take proper care of a disc. And I keep them in the case at all times when they're not being used. And, yeah, that, it sucks that the case is gone, because I remember the front cover is Sonic, like, running, obviously, but then the other half is him with his, like, with the claw out and shit. It's like half Werehog, half Sonic.
Ida! Yay, he's dead.
I'm joking. Oh my goodness. But yeah, we've been streaming for almost 2 hours and 30 minutes. I do hope you guys are enjoying the stream so far.
I thought I lost you.
I didn't see that comment. Heartless was a guess. And that's what they're actually called. Yeah, they're called the Heartless. Yeah. I have no idea why I thought they were called the Forgotten, though. Something like that. If Cameron was here, he would tell me, probably, because he's pretty big in Kingdom Hearts. And see, another thing that worries me, too, about doing a Kingdom Hearts playthrough is... he told me that game can be rage-inducing at times. And I try not to play games like that, because I get easily irritated. Like, I have a fuse about this long before I lose my shit. Especially when I'm playing video games.
Yeah. Oh my god, it's the Green Goblin. He kicked Spider-Man's booty.
Oh my god. On the Sega Genesis, the case were cardboard. That's maybe the reason. Also, if you want to see the Sonic Unleashed cover, I can see it. Oh no, I know what the front cover looks like for Sonic Unleashed, yeah. But, we're talking like PS3 cases, because when I was a kid, I had a PS3, and, he fucking, wait, oh shit, I got a trophy, wait, was victorious in every battle with the evil, how did I not get that, what? How did I not get that? But, the thing was, is that he would take the, because I had a PS3, he would take the, and the discs were, the cases were made of plastic, and he would take the cases, and he'd throw them away. And I don't understand why he ever did that. Because nowadays, because I have a shelf over here, you guys obviously can't see it, but it has every game I own, all in the cases. I don't ever throw cases away. Because I don't see a reason. I mean, it's like, they're meant to contain the disc. I mean, unless you have a disc book or some shit like that, there's really no point to throw it away. Doesn't make any sense. Okay. Jesus.
I'm a ballerina.
I'm joking. Alright, we gotta do tests. Honest to God, with that thing on her head, it kinda reminds me of when they do, like, seizure testing, where they put electrodes on people's heads, and whenever they have a seizure, it displays it on a screen and shit, like the lines and stuff. That's kinda what it reminds me of a little bit.
Okay.
Except, electrodes, they have to, like, glue to your head, I think. Which, I can't imagine that. Hold on 1 second.
No.
Sorry about that, guys. But I did not know the cases were made of cardboard, though, for the Sega Genesis. That was plastic.
Wow. I didn't see anything.
But, I gotta say, though, I really like the white aesthetic with the PS5. It's a nice change from black. Because the cases are, white on the PS5, which is pretty cool. It's very similar to Stranger Things. The you mean the game I'm playing, Beyond Two Souls? Yeah, it's sort of It's like Heavy Rain, which is, it's the same developer, which is Quantic Dream. Yeah. Which, speaking of Stranger Things, that is it. Oh, wait. No, no, I'm thinking of the wrong thing. Stranger Things is a TV show. I'm thinking of, Life is Strange. That's what I was thinking. I thought you were talking about Life is Strange for a second. I'm stupid. Yeah, Stranger Things is a TV show. Yeah, I know nothing about that show. All I know is that it's like a Netflix thing. That's all I know.
Hey, where are you going? Aren't you gonna wait for Nate?
I feel so bad, because I thought you were talking about Life is Strange. I'm stupid. Which, that game is kind of trippy, too, a little bit. Because, like, she can reverse time and shit. But I don't really know much about Stranger Things.
You look upset.
Oh, this is when she has to go to the CIA.
This is Ryan Clayton from the CIA. The agency. The agency wants you to join their military school program at Camp Perry. Ryan's gonna take care of you.
Oh, because she just said, excuse me? Like the look on her face was just, excuse me? What the fuck did you just say? Like, I ain't doing shit. She might be a useful asset. I'm just gonna say...
You're joking, right?
Yeah, he's totally joking. I'm just gonna say angry.
What am I, a toy? Some kind of a test?
Yeah, you're a baby toy. That's what you are. You're a baby.
Stop and think about what I want.
Jody, I know.
I mean, that is kind of fucked up, though. Difficult. It's like they're just using her because she'd be a useful asset. Isn't that fucked up?
Great opportunity for
you. Wow. The nerve of people.
You can tell the CIA to fuck off, because I'm not going anywhere.
Yeah, you are, Elliot.
Listen up, Miss Holmes. I don't give a shit about your pathetic adolescent pouting, all right?
Damn, what an asshole. One of the main characters, Stranger Things, is telepathy and telekinesis, and got tested very similar to that. Oh, okay. That's kind of cool, actually. Aw, damn. She's about to fuck you up now because of what you said.
Jody, stop immediately.
I mean, I understand how she feels, though. I mean, because imagine you have these powers, and the only reason anybody wants anything to do with you is because of what you can do. I mean, it's kind of fucked up. And like, if you think about it, in the grand scheme of things, like, they're just using her. Like, they don't even give a rat's ass. If she was just your average everyday chick, they wouldn't give a shit. The only reason they care so much is because, oh, you have a ghost friend. Like, Jesus. Bunch of assholes. Damn, she had no choice. She said, you can... I like how she said, you can tell the CIA to fuck off. I like how she just said it like that. Oh my god. So the next would be the camp training, probably. This is when they teach you how to, fight and shit. But like I said, there's really not much gameplay in this game. I mean, there's gameplay, but it's very limited. It's limited gameplay. Like, in the sense that the game only lets you do what it wants you to do. Like, basic movement, basic interaction, but that's really about it. Quick time events, and that's it. There's not much gameplay in this. If anything, it's more cinematic, if anything. It's more so a movie, I would say. Like, an interactive movie. Because, while I like this game for what it is, there's just not much gameplay in it. I mean, at this point, they should have just made it into a movie. Because this could very easily be a movie. What were they thinking? I'm joking. I like how you can just hear her crying on loop. It's like they just recorded Elliot crying, and then they just said, oh yeah, let's just loop the sound over and over again. Like, oh, just regular girl, but oh, you have two souls, nah, you're an item. Yeah, pretty much. I mean, it's fucked up. It's like they didn't even try to hide it. Like, at the very least, they could have hid the fact that they just wanted to use her. But good god, dude, really? They didn't even try to hide it. Oh wow, her teddy still comforts her, okay. I like how she just picks it up and then puts it down. Like, she's just like, okay, fuck you. Oh my god. I think you're supposed to put it in the bag. Well, she just picks it up and then just puts it down. That doesn't make sense, she's just like, just puts it down. I don't know, that was just really funny. Okay. I think I have everything. Got my teddy bear, got my blanket, got my feety pajamas, and I think I'm ready to go. Let's go join the CIA, everybody. If it even lets me. What else am I missing? I don't know what to do. Oh, am I supposed to do something with Ida? I don't know. Eventually, though, you're supposed they let you leave. This is one of the shorter sections. I noticed with this game, it kind of alternates a little bit. Like, in the sense that there's parts where it's short, and then there's parts where it's very long. And there's another part in this game that is just so long that it could have been a fucking game within itself. It's that long. Well, maybe not a game, but I would say more of a DLC. And it's in the desert. And by God, is it easily my least favorite section in this entire game. Because it is so long. It's so ridiculously long that it's actually comical. It's like, this could have been its own DLC. And that's probably the worst part of this game. Is the desert. I hate it. Oh my God, I hate it. Oh my jolly, or golly, whatever. Oh my golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this November. No, I'm joking. I don't know what to do.
What the fuck, man?
It was a joke. It looks very Tim Burton-like right there. Also, the fact that they don't give her privacy either. Yeah, that really sucks. Because they have cameras on her at all times. I mean, can you imagine trying to go to sleep at night only to have cameras pointed at you? I mean, that's like, fuck that. You get no privacy at all. That'd be a pain in the ass. That would just piss me off after a while. It's not going to get any privacy at all. Okay, I don't know. I got my toothbrush, right? Don't forget to brush your teeth. I'm joking. Oh my God. I guess she just has a pizza box sitting there. What a lazy fuck. Can't even throw the box away. It was a joke. I don't know anything about this. Okay, I'm sick of hearing Elliot Page cry. It's starting to annoy me. Wow. But the way that they made her look in this game, it's creepy how accurate it looks. I mean, I know that's what they can do nowadays. But even the way she walks, it's 100% accurate to Elliot Page. Because I would say I'm a pretty big fan of Elliot. But, like, I've seen just about every single movie that he's in. So I know how he walks, because I've seen just about every movie. So, I mean, I know how he walks, I know his mannerisms and shit. Kind of crazy. Or take her clothes. Don't forget to pack an outfit. I'm joking. Yeah, I'm just mocking the fact that she's really depressed about it. They don't even let to get. I mean, she is going to the CIA. I don't think they want her to have posters and shit. Like that. So finally, I can leave this fuck heap. Jeez. Oh, just leave. It's the same crying sound effect just looped over and over again. It's like they didn't even like they could have did like variations of her crying, but it's the same looped sound over and over again. Like, by God, you could have got a few extra, and then she dries with tears, fake tears. It's like when I'm changing my daughter's diaper. She screams like she's being stabbed, and then afterwards she's completely calm, like nothing happened. That shit drives me nuts when she does that too. It's like just a second ago you were screaming like you were gonna die, and now you're screaming as if, or now you're just as calm as can be, as if you're completely fine.
I'll come and see you as soon as I can.
Wow. I wonder if that A113 is a Pixar reference though.
You know that. Don't
the A113 Easter egg is a long story. It's kind of hard to explain. It's a running Easter egg throughout the Pixar films. I forget exactly what it is. It's like, it was the room number for a classroom or some shit at, like, Pixar Animation Studios or some shit like that. I don't know. Water. No, I'm joking. Oh, shit. Jesus. I actually got that from Assassin's Creed, ironically enough. When old man Altair was sitting down at that, like, I guess the fire that was outside. They asked him if he wanted anything, he just said, water. Like, separation. Is that the name of the level? So, it's possible to not threaten Clayton. And it's possible to spy on Clayton and Dawkins. Okay. I like how they do that, though, because it tells you the other percentage of players that did what they did. So, this is the training sequence. I think this will be where I stop. I think I'll do this really quick. Because it's not terribly long, so I'll just do it. And then once we do this, I think we'll be done for the night. And then we'll do this again probably tomorrow. Maybe. And then Sunday for sure we'll do this. Tomorrow is a bit of hit or miss.
Your room.
So yeah. Say like her cry could be cry, then her weeping and breathing, you know when you cry and you need. Yeah, like it's like they could have done variations of it, but it's the same looped sound over and over again. Like after a while it gets annoying, to be honest. Like I'd rather hear my daughter scream than hear that shit. Well, I don't know about that. I don't know if I'd go that far. Oh, this is fun, man. Yeah, what is this, Vietnam? Jeez. I seriously feel like I'm training to be in Vietnam. Jesus Christ, what is this? Fort Sumter, 1968 or some shit? The year that my mother was born? Oh, shit. But yeah, it's true, though. I mean, my kid, she screams when she is being literally stabbed whenever we change her diaper. But the ironic part is that she's perfectly calm whenever she takes a bath. Would you think she'd be screaming with that? I get it, you know, infants, they have sensitive skin and they're cold. I get it. But she screams like she's being attacked. I get it, that's how babies are, but good lord, sometimes it's like, really? Like, all I'm doing is unzipping your onesie. Can you not scream? Okay. Now, the annoying thing about this comic book, always screaming, but pretty much, like, at times it's like, all I did was unzip your onesie. That's all I did, and she starts. Like, it's almost like she knows whenever we're about to change her diaper, because she'll start even before I even get to the diaper. It's actually crazy. I like how he did that. Oh my god. So the annoying thing about this part is that if you fuck this up, you have to do it over again, like that. Just like that, like how I demonstrated that. Okay, got that. Got that.
Let's start again,
I did it right, what do you mean? Nah, but at least she's a good baby, it's just, she's kind of spoiled a little bit. She's spoiled in the sense that she's at that stage now where if nobody's holding her, it's the end of the world. And that can get kind of annoying, especially when you're trying to do stuff. Like, I'll sit down after making a sandwich to eat, and then she starts screaming. I'm like, oh god, let me get her. It's like, can I at least eat, Elise? Jesus. Oh, what a Billy Badass over here. He looks like some fat drunk you would see at the bar or something. Yeah. See, take cover. There's a part coming up here where you have to be entirely stealthy. And if you get spotted even once, you have to do it all over again. It's really annoying. But hopefully we don't get trapped on that. Like I said, this will probably be the finale. I think this is where we'll stop for tonight. And then we'll continue with tomorrow, probably. And if not, then we'll continue Sunday. And realistically, we should be able to beat this on the next stream. I don't really think we should be stuck on this game for that long. But, like, my hands are not baby glue. Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's, I get that that's just how they are. Like, they want to be held a lot. But sometimes with her, it's, like, actually ridiculous. Like, sometimes I'll just be sitting there to put her down. And like, she'll be knocked the fuck out, like, fast asleep. And it's like, as soon as you put her down, what are you doing? That's how she is. Like, what are you doing? Why'd you put me down? It's like, I mean, I get that's how they are, but she's 2 months old already, which is kind of crazy. Oh, God, I have to do math. Oh, my worst enemy yet. Oh, my God, it's the uTorrent logo. Look at it. You guys remember uTorrent, that torrenting software? Yeah, don't torrent, kids. It's not good for the environment. No, I'm joking. Yeah, definitely pirate shit, kids. You definitely won't get a call from your internet service provider telling you that you're a bad person. Because that happened to me once. My ISP detected that I pirated GTA 5 for the PC. And they said, yeah, you can't be doing that. They said, yeah, you do that again, you're going to court, buddy. I said, oh, shit. Oh, yeah. Another game I thought about streaming was Cluster Truck, which is, it's one of those games that's designed to be annoying, but it's like you have to get to the end without falling. And I think it's a PC game only. So, yeah. Okay. Hit that. Got that.
Got that. Got that. Got that. Okay, I got it. But see, the annoying thing is, during the training sessions, if you fuck that up, you have to do it all over again. But in normal gameplay, it doesn't matter, because if you just fuck it up, you just continue the fight. It's not like you have to restart the whole fight, so what's the point of me having to restart? I mean, I get they're trying to drill it into my head, like, you'll need this later, but there's not much combat in this game, so it really makes no sense. Oh shit. Okay, jump over this. Dive under this. Oh my god, it really feels like a military camp in Vietnam. Oh my god. Like, it's like they're training me to be a soldier. Like, this is literally military training. They do shit like this.
It's not a fucking Sunday stroll!
I like how he said it's not a fucking Sunday stroll. Hey, buddy, I'm trying. Why don't you do it then, you fat shit? Fatty shit fuck. No, I'm joking. It was a joke. Please don't crucify me. No, I'm joking. But I do hope you guys enjoyed the stream, though. It was fun. With a game like this, it's hard to stay entertained, because... I mean, look at what this game is. I mean, I'm not saying it's a bad game or anything at all like that. It's just, like I said, it caters to a very specific audience. Whoa. I don't want to see that now. That's nobody's business. How did I fuck that up? Oh, I thought I had the... Oh, yeah, I remember I got stuck with this. So you have to maintain the two orbs. I remember I was stuck on this for literally minutes at a time. I didn't know what I was doing. Because, like, I didn't read the directions. I'm like, what am I supposed to do? Oh, damn. Can I get a swig of water, Elliot? Jeez. It's like the game doesn't allow you to have a break. The game is forcing me to play. It's like, it's literally... Look, the game is moving my hands. I can't stop it. Oh, goodness. Oh, shit. What, do I gotta fight Bruce Lee now? That guy looks like Bruce Lee. Also, kind of looks like my daughter's pediatrician. Yeah. Oh, I hit the wrong fucking button, shit. Whoopsie. Apparently, I don't know the directions. Gotta shake my controller very intensely. Oh my god. But you know, the funny thing is that this game is available on PC. But it's... I played the demo on PC. It's not ideal with the mouse and keyboard. Matter of fact, this game is even harder to play with a keyboard and mouse. It's not worth it. It's just easier with a controller. That's all I can say. Much easier with a controller. After a hard day of work, you lay down and you go to sleep. So this is the part I was talking about. I fucked this up a few times on my first playthrough of this game. You have to watch out, because if you fuck up once, you have to go back to the beginning. But once you pass this, you pass the training part, and then that's when we'll stop. This part isn't terrible. But a few times I would get caught, and I'm like, what the fuck did I do wrong? Like, how did he see me? Like, is this fucking Manhunt or what? Oh my goodness. I have to use... Yeah, you have to utilize the item, too. It's kind of like Manhunt a little bit. Like, you can distract the enemies to kill them. Which I liked it. And then you take them down. Except this time you're not stabbing people in the eye with glass. Because, you know, this isn't Carcer City, this is nowhere land. I don't know what this game takes, boys. I don't even think they bother explaining it. Oh, shit, I didn't see that guy. Fuck. Yeah, he's gonna see me. I'm gonna have to restart. Yeah, he saw me. Fuck!
You wanna get shot?
Yeah, sure. Why not? I totally wanna get shot. Just like everybody else. Because that's what everybody wants. I rushed it. This warehouse, yeah, the game just takes boys in a warehouse. Oh my god. This takes boys in a warehouse. Okay. I like how he just said, you want to get shot? No, but do you want to get shot? It's like she shoots him and then there's a big shootout. Okay. I mean, the CIA is no joke, neither is the FBI, but... Like, they're doing, like, military shit. Come on now. My goodness. Okay. For this, I'm gonna have to focus, probably. So I can, not do this again. I don't have to repeat it again. That'd be nice, actually. Okay. He's gonna see me, isn't he? Wow. This guy has to be the biggest fucking idiot I've ever seen. Are you kidding me? How did he not see me? Dude, like, are you not self-aware? I mean, I guess look what's in front of you, but still.
Okay.
Go up here. Distract this guy right here. But overall, this part isn't really that difficult. I think there's a trophy to beat this without getting spotted, though. Which, I think I actually did do it before. Because when I streamed it, I beat it first go. The first time I did this playthrough. Because I have done a playthrough of this game. But it was much earlier. And my streams weren't... I mean, they were okay, but... My webcam looked like shit. And my lighting was really bad. When you're watching. When I'm watching. What do you mean? I'm sorry, I'm kind of stupid. I'm stupid, man. I'm a stupid man. Oh, shit. Honestly, I have a very short attention span, so I probably forgot what I said. I much apologize for that. Okay. I gotta see how many enemies I have left. Let me see. Well, that guy, I took him out already. So the only guy left would be, this guy right here. He'd be the only guy left. Can I get him from above? Can I air assassinate him like in Assassin's Creed? No, I'm just... Oh, you can! Wait a minute. It's not letting me, though. It, literally, I just saw the button prompt. When you're watching for trespass, you don't have tunnel vision. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was confused about that for a second. I'm like, huh? What? Oh, jeez. Sick. How do I climb back down? Are you kidding me? Once you're up here, you can't get down? Really? Oh, there we go. Yeah, you can air assassinate him. The first time I did this on my first playthrough.
If this wasn't an exercise, you'd be dead by now.
Oh, wow. Trick. She eventually becomes, or she, he eventually becomes a love interest towards her. And it's possible to do him, if you know what I mean. But I don't know how to trigger it, though. It's during that date mission. But you get a trophy for it. Of course, the developers are a bunch of perverts. That right there was definitely her smile right there. Holy shit. I guess they're just pushing her around like, you fucking punk. No, no, but I passed it, though. Welcome to the CIA. Kind of curious to see the percentages, though. So it's obviously possible to do this without being spotted. I'm not sure what tremendous fighter means. In good physical shape. So it's possible to fail training somehow. I wonder what happens if you fail training. Alright, so this would be a good stopping point. Gonna go back to the main menu. But, yeah. Oh my god, that is just terrifying. You really think I want her big-ass face on my screen? Okay. But, yeah, guys, I think that's gonna do it for tonight. I did really enjoy the stream. It was a lot of fun playing Beyond Two Souls. The game is... It is kind of slow-paced, but we'll get through it. We'll beat it eventually. But, other than that, guys, if there's any likes in the stream, I appreciate it. And all who tuned in, really do appreciate you. And, yeah, gonna hit you guys in the end screen. I'll see you guys later, so see you later, guys. Thank you.